Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another live stream video here on twitch.tv/Asuma, and straight away we have bananas in chat, so let's pause chat and let's say a big thank you to Asuma's dad, to Rocky Avalon, JG424, Netherbricks, Ems Kau, Jays on Fire, Jimmy, Pony Butts, Alien Explorer, The Wowie, Prime Pixel, Sir Loafington. Appreciate the bananas. Also a big thank you to Go for the Gusto, Hippie Gans, Timmy MC2, Toos112, Autumn as well, thank you for the chat, we love it. I can now read all the bananas. Owain Meadmaker, Prime Pixel again with more bananas, Frontline Rocks, Tech Guy, 1 Bazillion. Thank you for all of the bananas, and the Real Boy, 1302. Thank you for all the bananas, peeps, let's get into it. Yellow Harold has resubscribed for 5 months in a row. Asuma's dad has resubscribed for 13 months in a row. Madness, thank you for over a year of support, Asuma's dad, and thank you for the continued support, Yellow Harold. I hope you're enjoying your times on the Patreon server. I saw that you joined. Also, Rocky Avalon here with a donation saying, prank Mumbo, joke I'm a taco. There'll be no pranking a Mumbo. No pranks in the stream, remember? Because everyone spoils them. Hey, what's this fella doing right here, eh? Some sort of strange special dual stream or something. We have another resubscribe from JG424, 3 months in a row. And Crash Gadget has resubscribed for 4 months in a row. Brantafors for 5 months, saying, Wild Time really flies. And John Martin Holt Mione has subscribed, a new subscriber here on the channel. You guys are going crazy. We haven't even got started yet, and my stream alerts are going mental. They're going mental right now. Did he do that because I just did that? Let's see if we can get Ren to sort of psychically understand that I want him to mimic what I do. Can I jump? Yeah, he's now you gotta swing your arm, Ren. Swing your arm, Ren, come on, do it. Jump on. Oh, I thought he was copying what I do. We got the Snacker, another new subscriber here, and a resubscriber 7 months in a row from Zlot. Nilo, thank you so much for all of the support. Do appreciate it. Today we are doing a dual stream with none other than Ren the Diggity Dog here, my fellow log fella, here on the Hermitcraft server, and another resubscribe for 6 months in a row from Cal Terrain. Are you guys going to let me stream or what? I am getting resubscribes in one ear, in the other ear, and I don't know what to do right now. I am losing my mind. It's time to ring Ren, I think. I don't know if he wants me to ring yet, but we'll do it anyway. I was going to make a ringing sound, but I realise I'm not one for sound effects. So make your own ringing sound. It's ringing. Panda Hesus says, hey X, it's me, the guy who asked you about Panda's cuteness, fluffiness and intelligence. Just came to say, hey, hey. Welcome back, buddy. We've now got Rendog. I believe we have Rendog on the line.
Hello, Mr. Exemavoid. What's going on, dude?
Oh, I hear you, buddy. It's going good. Yeah. I am getting some crazy resubscribe action going on right now. It is mental, one after the other.
Okay, take it away. Do you take it away? I'll just sit back with Cyberdogs. We'll listen.
I appreciate that. I'm just checking my volumes. You sound a little bit quiet. Maybe I'll adjust that in a second. Okay, so we got another resubscribe from Spaceman Mark saying, "Yo, Lockfellas unite." I agree with that. We got another one here for 8 months in a row from Banana Nose Hair. Appreciate that. We also have some bits in chat. What is going on? Thank you for your cheers, your bits. From ACDog07 saying, more notifications. And Iskow85, who is on the server right now, isn't he? Has resubscribed for 5 months in a row saying, take it away. Appreciate that, buddy. Ren, the people are going mad for this.
The people are going mad, X. I have just got a resubscription myself from Pony Butts, a very well-known member of our community, who
Absolutely.
Has resubscribed for 5 months and says, looking snazzy in a tie. Ren, beautiful as always. Listen, X, I was just telling my viewers, I have dressed up for this evening's affair. I've
fancy.
Got me tie on. I've got me collared shirt on. You know, my mobster, I mean, business
mobster.
attire, you know.
Yes, I got my webcam out as well. I sort of positioned it all correctly, and then I went to turn it on, and I thought, oh, wait a minute, I'm standing up. All you can see is my torso. So I did away with the webcam. It makes no sense.
No,
I've got more notifications. Ren, people are going nuts today. I don't know what's going on. I've got another new subscriber, Oddflux. Welcome to the channel. Appreciate the support. Sniper1974 has resubscribed for 5 months in a row, saying, love the vids, you're amazing. Thank you so much, dude. Appreciate the support. And Mrs. Squirrely has subscribed. Welcome to the channel. Love the name, Mrs. Squirrely. That is awesome. And they're not letting me get away, man.
There's more?
They're not letting me... They are going mental. DS Lego has resubscribed for 2 months in a row. Thank you so much. Right, Ren.
Yes.
What are we doing? Quick, before they start resubscribing again.
We are going to be working on the speed tunnel. We put this bad boy together
yes.
in the previous Hermocraft episode. Pretty much In the previous episode.
There it is.
We put this amazing speed tunnel together, guys. This is a 40 block per second speed tunnel designed by Ragu42 on YouTube. Go check him out, man. He's a smart guy, and this tunnel's insane. X, today we're going to be trying to add the second line into this bad boy, aren't we?
Oh, yes we are, and it is going to be tricky stuff. Yep. I've got to say something, Ren. I thought there were different blocks on the walls here when I came down. There are light sources here.
Yes.
Oh, it's a torch. Okay, it's a torch. Yeah. Makes sense. I'm thinking though, it might be really cool to have the occasional window, but
yes,
it will have to be a very long window, because as you look out of it, it will be behind you.
Exactly, yeah.
You know what I mean?
X, I got some noises in me ear.
Oh, go on then.
Hang on, let me get that out there. I have got a fourth month resubscription from Mumble65. Thank you so much, Mumble65. Says, love the dual stream. You two are amazing. Thank you, Mumble65. And I got a little bit of a tingly bits in me ear too.
A tingly bits?
Yeah, tingly bits. I've just got a cheer from Ponybutts again, who cheered 100. How about Ren get some noises too? Thanks, Ponybutts. You see, Ponybutt got me back, man. Ponybutts got
She's
me
got
back.
You back.
So yes, the windows you were talking about, I was thinking about this just before we started a Kraken.
Yes.
I agree, we're going to have to make them a little bit longer. And I thought what we could do is maybe make them out of slabs so that they don't get blown up by ghasts. I don't know if that's something to worry about or not.
Here's how it works with slabs. Slabs don't block the view of a ghast. They can see through any gap, you know?
Okay. So
they see hitboxes, not, oh, there's a block there, I can't see anything. They see the hitbox.
But that's a bad idea.
It's an idea, but unfortunately it doesn't work. It'd be a good idea if it was old Minecraft. It probably worked in old Minecraft, you know.
Yep. I believe I did use them at some point in a gold farm build. I've got a couple of Shaker Babies going on in the house here, my friend. Shaker Babies, of course, people who donate to me. Rita Hartnell says, someone's all dressed up with nowhere to go. So ready for the stream today. Thank you, Rita. Very much appreciated.
So, I'm looking at this thing and I'm thinking a couple of things. One is carpets on top of the slime blocks will stop mobs spawning on it. The other is carpets on the ground will stop mobs spawning on it. And now I'm thinking, how can we get a ridiculous amount of carpets?
Well,
probably from string, right?
Yes, or from the sheep farm that we've got on the server.
Yes, but it's not really practical for the amount that we would need. And if you were to use all of the sheep in there, then you'd have a multicolored floor, and that would probably drive some people mad.
look what cheeky fellow's just arrived here, Rex, looking all suited and booted. What's going on here?
I'll tell you what, he's watching the stream. He wants to be a part of it, man. He's coming over here. He's listening. I bet he's listening right now.
He is. He's definitely listening. He's got an arrow in his brain, too, which is slightly
two diamonds
worrying.
Each. Hmm.
64 wools for 2 diamonds.
Hmm.
That's
Ren, you know, I'm thinking that's a good price considering we can't buy it from a certain someone else cheaper, you know?
Yeah, that's a good point. I don't have any bling blings on me, though.
Neither do I. I think we're good. I think we will find a way to... Because, like, think about how much we... And we're building it to this guy's project. And he's trying to charge us for making him a tunnel. The cheek.
That is pretty cheeky. He is Swedish, though, so, you know, it's understandable.
It is definitely cheeky. Ren, I've got to pause you there for a minute. I'm getting noises in my ear left, right, and centre again. We have two new subscribers. We have Boges Man NL, who's joined us on the Patreon server. Boges, thank you for your subscription. And Benny the Scales has subscribed as well. Appreciate you both. But also Chris J1024 has resubscribed for 7 months in a row. I am getting so many follow noises that the subscriptions come through in little intervals, it feels like.
Yeah, that's what's happening to me too.
Yeah.
I think it's all the cyberdogs hitting you up there, X.
Everyone is just hyped for some Logfella action right now. So thank you everyone for the follows. If you're watching here on my channel, go over and check Ren's out as well. You're streaming with me, and the moderators will provide some links in chat for you to watch both streams at once. If your internet can handle it, you know, some dual Logfella action, why not?
Exactly, man. I've got the same problem. My notification noises are about 3 minutes behind. I've just got another 5 month resubscription from Rocky Avalon. Thank you, Rocky Avalon. 5 times a bacon here on Rendog TV. That's freaking awesome.
Did I just hear a ghast die? I see XP.
Yep, I wrecked it.
Oh, well done you. I didn't even see you shoot it. It was just like, oh, a ghast has apparently died.
Yeah, I got it with one shot. Usually they get a spit off or two at myself, and it's not pretty. Ghast and I are not good friends, X. I have lost no less than 3 full sets of fully enchanted mending gear on the server because of ghasts.
That's not the ghast's fault. I'm sorry to break it to you. I bet that's because there's no fire pots in your inventory, right?
Fire pots. We've had this discussion before. Fire pots are for noobs.
Dude, I feel a prank coming on, you know? like building a giant fire pot potion, that's not too difficult. I could do something like that. Could fill your base with fire pots. You'd still forget to bring them.
I just wouldn't use them. That's the honest truth. You know what else? We've got a bit of a problem here, X. We're running out of materials, of resources. We're almost out of stone here.
I'm going to have to go get some cobblestone from the secret place.
From the secret place?
Yes. The place that people can't see. It means I've got to turn off my stream. No, not the stream. Sorry, my screen for a moment.
Okay.
Made people panic there. Apologize, peeps. Didn't mean to do that. Ender chest in the middle of the room. I got a noise in my ear as well from Pony Butts saying, I can't give Ren some noises without giving you noises too. Thank you, Pony Butts. Appreciate it as always. Some cheers and some bits in my ears, and that sounds really strange.
That did sound kind of odd. Ren, guys, listen, thanks so much. X, we were like talking. We're like, we're going to have a chilled out, relaxed stream. But the peeps are hitting us with a lot of noise tonight, man. So that's awesome.
They are. I've got a from Living NYT Mare. That's Living Nightmare. X beverage reminder. Do you have a beverage, Ren?
Oh, I have the most delicious cup of beverage that I love. Cup of beverage? Is that?
It's a thing. Cup of beverage. Say it, everyone in chat. Cup of beverage.
Hashtag cup of beverage. I've got a massive, and when I say massive, this teacup holds like a liter, I think. Ooh.
And that's ginormous, Steve.
It's ginormous.
Oh, wait. I did a bad thing. A bad thing.
What have you done?
I went through the... Oh, thank goodness. The spoilers, man. I've got to avoid them. Oh, panic attack. You're good. Continue.
Good.
Continue, my friend.
I have about a liter's worth of a tea from South Africa called Rooibos. I believe Lipton's makes a variation called Red Bush.
Ooh.
I'm not sure if you've sampled this variety of tea before.
I have never even heard of it.
Well, let me tell you something. It is tasty, man. Tasty.
It sounds pretty cool. Ren, I'm gonna see if you can guess what beverage I have today, and I want my chat to guess my cup of beverage as well.
It's
as
too it easy, man.
You think it's easy?
Yeah.
You think you know me, Ren? Come on, guess.
Dude, come on. You've got a cup of Asahi tea. Duh.
No.
What?
Nope, not today.
What?
I'll tell you all now, it's no Assam tea, it's no English breakfast, it's no peppermint, it's no green tea, it's something fancy.
Something fancy?
Yes.
Is it a tea?
Someone knows in my chat, Pony Butts knows, probably
Pony
knows
Butts
what
knows
it is.
Pony Butts knows it too well, X. Okay,
I really want to see if she gets it now, because she'll probably get the hint. Sorry, continue. Oh, is it a tea? No, no tea.
No tea,
I'm scanning my chat. I'm seeing apple juice. We've got some Earl Grey, but that's, no one has guessed it yet. Wine? Lemon tea? Coke?
Is it wheat grass?
The Minecraft food? Man 757 says tears of Rendog.
Dorshal says jasmine tea? That's pretty fancy.
No. There's no tea in it.
No tea, guys. It's not tea.
Absolutely no one is guessing it. I'll tell you that. I think Pony Butts must be AFK as well.
Doggeraf says water.
Water, mate. I've got some water here. That's technically right. Pony Butts says, I know. It's not tea. I don't. I'll tell you what I have, Ren. I have a honey and lemon. Ooh.
A honey
no
and
lemon?
What, just hot water with honey and lemon in it?
Yeah, man. No one guessed that.
Man, that sounds delicious.
It does, doesn't it? And Ren, once again, the people are going ham with the subscribing. I mean, they're going to break Twitch at this rate. We have 3 new subscribers.
Yep.
Trickilac has subscribed. EpicK910 and Naxila. Thank you for the subscriptions. Really do appreciate the support.
Oh,
hope you enjoy
Naxila is I think, is a long-time member of my community. So
oh, really?
Thank you, Naxila, for supporting X. That's amazing.
That's fantastic. Yeah, thank you so much. There's lots of crossover names. Like when you're mentioning your people, yeah. I'm like, I know these people.
I know these peeps. I've got loads of sub noises in me ear, but I think that they are way behind the followers in the thing. So guys, I'm sorry if I'm missing your subs. I can hear the noise in my ear, but I'm not going to be able to see your guys' subs until the follow queue is cleared.
Yeah, there's so. Definitely. I'm getting the same thing here because they come through in waves. It's really strange. Whoa, whoa. Okay, noise alert.
Was that you?
That was me. Oh. Ah, it hasn't been fixed, Ren.
What hasn't been fixed?
The tunnel. It was broken last night, and it hasn't been fixed.
Yeah,
so
it hasn't been fixed.
I'm going to look at that right now.
Slime.
Ah, here's where it's broken.
I tell you what, X, I'm going to go to the chunk farm and get a bunch of slime, okay? Because we're going to
Ren, when you're at the chunk farm, could you do me a favor and pick up some chunks?
Okay, I will. Some chunky Kit Kats. Ooh, chunky Kit Kat with my tea right now.
Oh man, I'll tell you what. Today is a day that I could do with a chocolate bar. Earlier, I had a real like crash. I finished recording some Hermitcraft. I had an hour and I was like, right, quick, time to move some boxes around, do some stuff. And then after that, I just felt my energy like zap away. And on a day like that, I always think it's a good idea to have something sugary. It's one of the reasons I made honey and lemon, actually. I'm hoping it'll give me a little bit of a boost, you know, keep me going.
I got a noise in my ear. Sable Parks resubscribed for 2 months. Thank you very much, Sable Parks. And just got a ding-a-ling, too.
A ding-a-ling?
Big cheer from Rocky Avalon. Thank you, Rocky Avalon. Very generous cheer from you. I thank you. I'm still trying to figure out what to call a cheer. I think I'm going to go with ding-a-ling.
I'm referring it to thanks for your bits and stuff like that, but I haven't got a proper solid thing. I like ding-a-ling. It reminds me of Shabaranks.
Yeah.
He's got a song where he goes ding-a-ling-a-ling. Have you heard Shabaranks?
No, but that sounds like a tune I'd like to hear.
Like, yeah, you will know this man's voice. Like, he is sort of like the almost stereotypic voice of, let's say, like, reggae or ragga kind of music, man. Trust me, you'll know this guy.
Nice. What tunes have you got banging out this evening, X? I got some acid jazz in my ears.
Acid jazz? That sounds amazing. I got me some Stellar Drone again. See, I have a small selection of artists, and I tend to put the same ones on over and over again. Stellar Drone is very spatial ambience kind of sound, you know? Oh, geez, I didn't press that quick enough.
That sounds fancy, dude. Spatial ambience?
Yes, it makes you feel like you're, you know, on the NASA spacecraft heading towards the moon.
Yeah, we got some problems, X. I'm here at the chunk farm. I've managed to get only 111 or 101 slime balls.
Oh, because we're going to need a lot more, aren't we?
Yeah, a lot.
I believe somewhere I might have a stash. I will go check the stash. I know where it is. It's going to be a while because I'm going to be placing droppers on my way back.
Okay.
Right. I just got two subscribes back to back, by the way. I think Twitch is doing its thing where they'll roll in. But continue, my friend, continue.
Is there another slime farm on the server? Does our good friend the Swede Iskall have a slime farm? I know he's got a pumpkin farm.
I don't think he does.
It
would make sense for him, of all people.
Yeah,
that's a scallion farm.
Does Mumbo have a slime farm?
I don't think so. What does he call slimes then? Escaliites?
What, the little, like, the actual living slimes?
Yeah, he needs a pet escaliite, you know?
He does need a pet escaliite. That's a great idea.
Another idea for a prank.
Yep.
Getting lots of those today.
Oh, man, hang on. Chicken Shadow saying, I have no sound. Chicken Shadow, I think that might be your end, but guys, if there is no sound, then this has been the most awkward stream of all time.
Yeah.
I think there is some sound.
If you have an issue and no one else is crying about it in chat, then it's quite likely it's on your end, is the way it goes. Blue
Citra
Flame
says you could
borrow
some escallion.
Oh, we might be able to. Yeah, Blue Flame says, X, that thing is crazy fast. Make sure you don't go back to the future. # back to the future. Amazing.
Yeah. As we mentioned in the episode, that thing discombobulates your soul.
Zlot Nilo says there's a slime farm in the Super Chunk. The Super Chunk is where you are, right, isn't it?
Yeah, that is where I am. I suppose I could hang out here. I don't know how fast it fills up with slime, but I'm guessing it's pretty quick if it's a slime chunk.
Yes. I just got distracted. Ponybutt sent me a message saying, speaking of pranks, did you enjoy your Sheepex? People were telling me the other day that you and Iskow did something, and I can't remember where they said to go. Where am I supposed to go?
Yeah, we did do something. We were naughty.
Okay, and whereabouts were you naughty?
if you know where you have your sheep, like, they walk back and forth munching on grass, like, underneath your base?
I was in that room earlier. I didn't see anything. I went straight into a chest looking for redstone.
There might be something awry there in that room. Dear.
Okay.
You have to open your eyes, though. You have to be... Let's see if your viewers can spot it.
Okay. I'll let them figure it out. We'll go there in a minute. I want to say a big thank you to... Vicar of Dibley. I get it. Has subscribed. Thank you for subscribing. Do appreciate your support. It feels a little bit crazy to do this, standing in such a dangerous area. We have a resubscribe for 2 months in a row from Sable Parks. Thank you so much, Sir Loafington, for 5 months in a row. Didn't I get that one a moment ago? And Bob Sheruncle for 3 months in a row. So many of these people have got, like, puns for names, you know. Vicar of Dibley and Bob's Sheruncle and... Another new subscriber it is, Danger Beasts Sweets. Thank you so much for the subscription, and Dear Shemmy for 5 months in a row. Ren, they are rolling in as I'm talking to you.
Mine are rolling in too now. Something fierce. Dude. 2 brand new subscribers. Sweaters JPG, Wizards Shot 123, all of my subs. Can we get some Zombie Brain Cocktails for the new sub hype? Welcome, guys, to Ren Dog TV. Thank you very much.
Brain Cocktails. Do you know what? I think you're getting them coming through when I am. I think it's just the way Twitch works. Like, it's rolling them all in little intervals, it seems, because we're getting some synchronized subscribing going on here. It's crazy. Oh, he's looking for you in chat.
I'm getting a little bit of lag on my stream again. For some this program that I use to stream, it's annoying, X, because I've recently updated it and it's just thrown all me settings out and everything is like, it's just infuriating. Every now and then it starts to record the stream direct to my hard drive, and that, like, completely messes everything up.
Do you know what you need? Backups. Backups, man.
Yeah. So listen, I'm going to hand over the stream to you for a second. I just want to go check my settings.
Okay, I want to say a massive thank you to Rocky Avalon for the cheer, for the bits, for the noise in the ear, saying only the best for the best. Thank you so much, Rocky. Appreciate it. As always, and a new subscriber here with Victor Ica 200. Thank you for subscribing. I need to look at the face. I need to look at my face when it's a... And wait, what? That sounded so strange when it's a new subscriber. Let's turn over to chat here for a little bit. You guys have been neglected somewhat. There's an Iscow right there. And he's putting down a chest. And I bet it's full of wool. And I bet he's going to try and sell me this wool. It's red wool. Interesting.
False Symmetry is also in the stream chats, XO. Big shout out to False, everybody. Can we have some love for our fellow hermit,
hey,
False Symmetry, who is hanging out in the chats?
I'm wondering. He's putting diamonds in there as well. Oh, he wants to... Oh, I see what he's... Hey, oh, I got his diamonds! Doing the off. I've got his diamonds. Oh, I'll give them back to him, actually. Oh, ow. Oh, so aggressive. Hang on. How am I supposed to give a man a diamond when he's, have him back. Take him back. Jeez.
My goodness, X. 2 sounds in my ear. 1 from Eagle Fam, a massive donation, who says, love you guys working together. Thank you, Eagle Fam. I really appreciate that. And another one from McCanny Valor, who says, so glad you two are streaming together. Can't afford another subscription right now, but here's a little something for a nice cuppa. Thank you very much, McCanny. I really appreciate that, guys. You're awesome.
I just pinched one of Iscal's diamonds. He's upset.
Oh. You owe me 30 diamonds? When did
we agree to this number of 30 diamonds? Well, I got one. I got one for you, Ren, you can pay him back with. That's for sure.
Okay, fantastic.
Whereabouts are you, by the way?
I'm in the chunk farm waiting for a little bit more slimage.
Okay, I'm going to go to my base and see what's happening here.
Okay, I'm trying to figure out... Because I think I've got a little bit of lag here. But I'm not sure. Guys, could you just let me know? Is my stream lagging for you? If it's unwatchable, please let me know. If not, I'm just going to go with it.
Someone in chat, Lucid Knight, is asking, what acid jazz band is Ren listening to?
Oh, goodness. It's a playlist. It's just a playlist of many different songs. I didn't find them or, like, search for them. I just downloaded a few, like, compilation albums, you know? Of some acid jazz, and yeah, turned out pretty good.
Yeah, people have got a choice of what they want to listen to as well, as a perspective. Yeah, because if they want to listen to some Stellar Drone, if they want to listen to some acid jazz, you got a choice. Ren, I've got a pink sheep here. It's not the most alarming thing I've ever seen. Is that it? Just a pink sheep?
Well, It's a pink sheep, but isn't there something a little bit special about that pink sheep?
Not that I can see. Really? If you use the name tag on it, you can't see their names. Is the problem. Did you use the name tag on it?
Well, let's just say that the hashtag for the evening was get flipped.
Okay, right. Fear the Saints. There's no name tag on the pink sheep. I don't understand, Ren.
Okay, hold on. I'm coming over.
Is this a Ren Dog trademark prank that I've heard about?
This was an Iskall idea, and it turned out real good. We did it on stream together, and it was fantastic. And we were... I hope that it has actually worked, but it worked when we did it. I wonder if the server has reset the sheep, though.
It might have. Come have a look.
Yeah. Oh, that is unfortunate. Well, yeah, the pink sheep's in there. So basically, X, we flipped it upside down.
Ah, that's a bit odd. It didn't save that. You did a grum or a dinner bone.
Yeah.
and Ren, we've been streaming for 26 minutes. I'm going to remind you to take a sip of your cup of beverage, which is what I need to do right now.
I shall have that little cup of beverage sip. Thank you.
Oh, it's very lemony.
X, I'd like to say 510 viewers on my stream. Amazing. Thank
That's
you guys
fantastic.
So much.
I actually Amazing. Can't see mine because apparently I goofed. I've got 2,273 over here. Peeps, let's get Rendog's numbers up. Come on. Some of you load up those dual streams. You can watch both at the same time.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Dual perspective. I'm getting the noises in the ear again. I've got to keep up with this before they disappear off the screen. Sammy Nugget YT is here cheering, saying, love the streams, X. Also, what's faster? Flying straight down with an elytra or this? What's this? I don't know. What is the this? No idea, Sammy.
Speedway? The speed tunnel?
Ah, yes. The speed tunnel is faster than flying with elytra, I think. Unless you're going full pelt downwards elytra speed, maybe it's faster for a bit. I got a new subscriber here. It is Zweinstein2301. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Also, FlameAbyss530. Thank you for the subscription. And What Us has resubscribed for 7 months in a row. Do appreciate it. We also have a donation from EagleFam saying, I love when you stream together. So much derpage. The peeps do seem to like us streaming together, don't they?
They do. There is a lot of derpage involved, but that's fine. That's fine. I got a couple of noises in my ear too, X. A donation from Captain Irony who says, only here for a few minutes. Can you please call Iskall86 in chat for me? Have a good day. And I also got a 5th month resubscription from John Rang. Thank you guys so much. Very much appreciated. And there we go. Exuma did it for you already. So
there we go. I'm on the ball. Just Andy H says, Asuma, I just subbed to Ren, so you should have tea reminders. He's awesome. Using a Rendog TV beverage as well.
Oh, a zombie brain cocktail.
Yes, yep. I can't actually see that yet because I'm using a custom chat program, but hopefully that stuff will come later. This is amazing. I can press spacebar and the chat pauses. I can press it again and it just resumes. It is very nice. Streamlined. It removes, you know, Nightbot and people mentioning other people. Like, it's so much easier to work with.
Oh, you got to hook me up with that, dude. That sounds amazing.
Yeah, I can definitely talk to Autumn about that. Absolutely. Oh, are we're putting blocks there, are we?
Well, I kind of want to figure out where the roof is.
Okay, well, I've already started placing droppers, so I'm not sure what height the droppers were at. I can't remember if they were directly on top of it or not. What I'll do is I'll craft up some more and go around and do another round of that.
Okay, cool.
Do we use all the cobble already?
Yeah.
Jeez! Yeah. Okay, let's put some of these away.
we actually need an insane amount of cobble. I don't have any cobble left, unfortunately.
I will get some cobble for us.
We actually need stone, though, because we're going to make this tunnel out of stone brickage.
Ah, I've got loads of that as well.
Should I come with you?
You should definitely come here.
Okay.
Yeah. This chest you can raid for slime blocks.
Ooh. Yeah.
This one also over here is 20. Take all the slime from those chests that you need.
Okay, fantastic.
The stone I would leave there, I will get, because I've counted up all the amounts, so I will get stone. This next area that I'm going to is a spoiler-free zone, so I'm going to have to turn off my screen again.
Okay. And here's a bunch of stone. Yeah, I see a bunch of stone here, so that's good.
Let's click the Minecraft off. Don't worry, peeps. Don't panic. No alarm.
So X, I reckon we split this task up between us, right? Make it go a little bit quicker. I shall work on the stone wall edge of the tunnel.
Yes.
You get the dropper action going on.
Can
and
do.
Then we can come together to put to work on the slime piston action.
Yep, that sounds good. Gotta say, I'm slightly terrified of the wall building myself, like walking across those walls while imminent death is below. By the way, the other day I fell and I survived in the Nether. I fell really far down and I didn't think to tap spacebar when I'm like wearing my elytra. You know, gotta keep these things in mind. And I'm terrible at doing that, as I'm sure
you know. I've forgotten that many, many times. And then I've died, lost all my stuff, and then I've suddenly realized if I just hit spacebar, I would have been fine.
So, dude, you know? my notifications are going off the screen now. I've got to get on top of these.
Okay,
Mini1025 says, keep the noises going. More streams with Rendog. Thank you for the donation, buddy. Do appreciate it. Panda Grove has resubscribed for 5 months in a row. And Green Tuck. Green Tuck, no, not Green Truck. 13 has subscribed. Thank you for your subscription. Welcome to the channel. We also have donations from Dear Shemi saying, gotta love them noises. Keep it up, X. And also a sword bag 822 saying, love this project. Looks great. Thank you so much. Appreciate all of the support, peeps. And one more just came in right now. Cage Min Good saying, what is your favorite cake? Ren, do you have an answer for that? I'm going to have to think about this one.
I love me a little bit of... what's my favorite cake? is Mull the Pudding a cake? Does that count?
Mull the Pudding?
Yeah.
I've never heard of that. Is that a South African delicacy?
Yes. I think you guys call it sticky toffee pudding.
Oh, that reminds me, Ren. Yes, I... So yeah. My favourite puddings or cake... Well, the question was cake more than pudding, wasn't it?
we might as well move on to cake, though.
Yeah.
I mean, pudding.
I like a... Was it a Belgian bun? You know?
Belgian bun.
Yes. Well, they got in raisins, sultanas, and icing on top. I also like Eccles cakes. They're delicious.
Ooh, yeah.
And when it comes to pudding, the sticky toffee apple, my mum makes that for me on occasions with pear instead of apple. And I'll tell you what, it is absolutely delicious.
That sounds amazing.
I had a bowl the other day. It was so good.
We started streaming 2 hours earlier than I usually stream, and I haven't eaten anything. And now all I want to shove in my face is that pear toffee cake that your mum makes. That sounds amazing.
It is. It is so. I'll have to fetch the recipe for you, man.
Barsonian says, Rendog, from which country are you? I am from South Africa originally, my friend, but I have been living in England for the last 10 years or so. So my accent is a little bit of a mess. Lots of people think I'm from New Zealand, Australia, and very strangely enough, X, a lot of people think I'm from America, which...
Really?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Which doesn't make any sense to me at all, although I don't know. I don't sound American, do I?
You might have a little bit of Americanness here and there, but same for me as well, because, you know, if you watch a lot of American TV, some words might rub off on you different, you might say them different, something like that.
That's true.
Right then.
So, yeah, 700 viewers, X, my goodness, guys.
They're coming over. They're tuning in to say hello to you, man.
I always tell my viewers that whenever I go get over 500, that's when, like, the sweats kick in, you know? That's when
Dude,
I get nervous.
You get the stream sweats.
I get the stream sweats, man. This shirt that I'm wearing this beautiful, like, mobster shirt. It is going to be soaked by the end of this jazz, man. Let me tell you.
I'm getting stream sweat right now, and I don't know why. It is dripping down my arms. It's dropping onto the floor. It's quite disgusting. I've talked about this before. Every now and then when I'm recording or streaming, my body just starts, like, this steady, patient sweat. And I don't even, like, feel particularly why, you know, no form of panic, stress.
Yeah.
It just happens. It's like my body's just figuring something out and it's going, you need to sweat now. It's very, very odd.
About 3 months or so ago, I went on holiday in Mauritius. It was my mother's 60th and it was like this huge family event and we'd been planning it for years to go to Mauritius as a family.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you've been to Mauritius, X.
I have not. When you said it then, I think I've only heard of this place a couple of times before. You mentioned to me a while ago. Where is it in the globe?
It's on the east coast of South Africa, sort of near the Seychelles Islands. It's like on the east coast of Africa, basically, near the middle of it. Very near to the equator. Now, it's a picturesque place, you know, like palm trees and coconuts and all that jazz. But let me tell you something, dude. The heat is something fierce beyond fierce. I I sweated in places that I didn't even know you could sweat when I was there, man. It was crazy. It was
that absolutely sounds crazy. That sounds cool. I don't like the heat myself.
Yeah,
you know, I like the cold, and I like to make myself warm if I want to feel warm. You know what I mean?
I hear you. That's why I love England so much. There's no sun. It rains all the time. It's cold. It's miserable weather. It's perfect for a YouTuber. It's the perfect YouTuber country.
It is. And the hot days are over, man. There's been some real hot days in August.
Yeah.
And you know, autumn's coming now, and I love. I think autumn and autumn. Do you know, I love winter, but every time it's winter, I'm like, sometimes it is a bit too cold. I love the autumn, the late season, you know?
Absolutely, man. I got a noise in me ear, X, from Diesel Architect, who says, Ren and Exuma, you guys got any plans for some Logfeathers gear like shirts? I need to show my allegiance to the Logfather so he doesn't put Speedy's head in my bed sheets.
That's a fantastic idea. Immediately, Pony Butt's names come to mind. So, Ren, I don't know how you do your t-shirts, but mine are all commission-free. Like, I used to sell them, and then I sort of thought, do you know what? Like, you make a few extra pennies off of this, but it doesn't feel like it's worthwhile. If someone wants to spend money on a t-shirt of mine, I'm so flattered, I would rather them just have it as cheap as I can get it for them. So, Pony,
I totally agree
up
with you. And awesome. I can pretty much guarantee Pony Butts is working on a design
now. She's already drawing it, you know what I mean.
Yeah, she's got the pen out, she's got the pencil and the paper out, she's going for it. I do exactly the same thing when I first set up my selling some merch. You know, the thing is, you can't sell a t-shirt for a lot of money, you know? It's unreasonable. So, you know, when I set up the shop and, you know, you sell a t-shirt for $10 or whatever, right?
Yeah.
And you make maybe 50 cents from it. So for me, it just didn't ever make sense to do that. So I always sell merch at cost because, you know, if people want the merch, I'd rather give it to them than try and make like a tiny little 50 cent profit or something.
Yeah, absolutely. So I guess since we're both on the same page, it's probably like I wouldn't like to just make this decision on a stream, so we won't, but we'll talk about it after. But I love the idea of making some Logfellas t-shirts. That really does sound like a fantastic idea.
That does sound like a good idea. Maybe a Logfellas mobster tie. I mean, business tie that people could wear to the office, you know?
That sounds good. I'm already picturing like an axe on the shirt and like one of the names, like Spruce Willis.
Yep. So, X, I had a question for you.
Yes?
How do you like suit and ties? What is your opinion on, you know, getting dressed up, wearing ties?
I never want to wear a tie and a suit in my life. It is my life mission to get away with never wearing a suit. That is absolute truth right there. There's something about wearing a suit that I really don't like, you know?
Uh-huh.
Like so dressing up for someone else's expectations, you know?
Are you the hippie in the corner at a wedding, like in your shorts and shirt?
Yeah, I probably look like that. but I don't like the term hippie. I'm not a hippie. Like, I just don't like being labelled with anything, you know? I just like to be me and be me for me, not because, you know, there's some movement or thing, you know? I'm going to go get some more cobble, by the way. I've also got noises in my ear to catch up on. We've got a donation here from BDoggy7 saying, hey, X, love the stream. Keep the Logfellas alive and the noise is coming. And we've also got one here from AssuredBag822 saying, hey, X, what's your favourite version of Minecraft on, as in updates like 1.9, 1.10, 1.11, etc.? That is a great question.
Very
I want to say
question.
A massive thank you to both of you. Appreciate the support. And that sounds like a little bit of discussion right there. Ren,
yep.
How long have you been playing Minecraft for? Oh, wait, I'm going to... Spoils! Jeez, concentrate, X! Concentrate!
I've been playing Minecraft since 1.2 release.
Right, so you have been playing it, I think, a little bit longer than I.
Yep.
And
I still know absolutely nothing about this game.
My memory is fading a little bit with it, like... I was watching through some of my Mythbusters recently because I've been doing, you know, episodes that involve like going back and looking at what I've done before, and it's really good to like learn the stuff again. But I'm like, man, I wish I could remember more things, you know.
Yeah.
Need more capacity. For me, I think my favourite update of Minecraft will always be 1.7.2.
Okay.
Because it just felt so significant to get pistons in the game. Like they were just a humongous game changer. And it came at a time when I was like really starting to get into it and thinking about making videos, you know, approaching that sort of stage. So it like, you know, it feels like a good... Some people got some really big spoilers, by the way.
Oh, no. Don't mention it, X. Maybe they'll forget.
Yeah, yeah, everyone forget.
Well, that's very interesting. And obviously, you know, Pistons were great for you as a Redstoner and as a designer in this game. Myself, I'm not a Redstoner at all. So Pistons, you know, I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. But it didn't really float my boat that much.
Yeah.
I got to be honest, and this might be a bit cliched, I suppose, but I would say that my favorite Minecraft update so far is 1.9.
Really?
I feel like the Elytra is one of the most awesome things that the game's ever got. And
you're right. The Elytra is good for 1.9. I've moaned so much about this, and I'm gonna say it as briefly as I can.
Oh God, here we go, everybody.
It took a long time to go from rapid clicking to click slower. And there were no new weapons. You know, well, there's the shield. No new mobs, you know. Yep. Well, there probably was one, I forget. It was disappointing, 1.9 for me, but the Elytra was a little gem inside that update.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
You know, the Elytra is classic. Everyone loves the Elytra.
Absolutely. I suppose, yeah, I mean, for me, you know, lots of people complain about Minecraft a lot, and the game gets a lot of hate, but for me, I think that the updates so far, the game has progressed in a really positive and a really good way for me. I am enjoying the game more than I think I ever have. I don't see myself stopping playing this game for many years to come.
I don't know what it is.
I was thinking about it today before we started streaming, and I building this project with you has been really cool because it's basically made me realize, and playing with Iskall also, because Iskall is a Redstone genius, and I play a lot of Minecraft with him, and you guys have shown me stuff that I never even thought you could do in this game, and it's made me realize that I still have, I probably know 10% about this game.
Yeah, you realize you've got the Redstone universe to explore now.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Going back to what you were saying about still loving this game, like, you know, I'll talk to some of my friends, they know what I'm doing, and it's like, oh, you know, you're still enjoying it then. It's like, yeah, of course. And like, they've never played Minecraft, they don't get it. It's this constant freedom to, you know, envision something and make it happen, and it's a constant sense of reward for the time that you put into it, you know. Today, I did some organic building, right? I don't do this too often. I sort of looked at something, I went, I don't have a plan. I'm going to do it block by block and see what we can create. And I came up with some really cool looking stuff. I was so pleased with how it turned out, and now that stays on this server, and other people enjoy it as well. That stays here. I can walk past that and go, yeah, that turned out great. Other people are enjoying it. You know, sometimes you work together like we are right now, and I'll remember, you know, the fun times we had doing this thing whenever, you know, I walk past it and see it. And that's what the server is. It's just like a hall of memories everywhere. It's brilliant.
Exactly. I mean, one of the things I love most about this game is that the more people you play with, the more time you spend in the game, the better you get at it, right?
Yeah.
And it's amazing to like look back to the stuff you made years ago and then look to what you can create now. And you're literally seeing your own progression as like an artist. I call Minecrafters artists because we're using this palette, this giant canvas of a game, to create stuff. And
absolutely.
I believe in a way that it is art. And as artists, we are improving every single hour that we play. And it's amazing for me to see. And you know what, X? Another point that I want to make while we're on this. I'm getting hyped up about this topic. Okay? this is good stuff. I've recently started my season 5 of my survival series. And I've seen a lot of people watching the series saying, whoa, Rendog, slow down. I've just started playing Minecraft. I really want to know how to do this. Like, I've just recently made an enchanting table, right? And I was going like super fast through the whole process. And I read these comments saying, slow down, dude, I've just started playing Minecraft. And what I realized is that there are people that have never played this game starting to play Minecraft every minute of every single day.
Constantly new people are joining.
Exactly. And this game ain't going nowhere.
I'm
going
to put it to my chat. If you have been playing this game for, less than 2 weeks, put a message in chat saying less than 2 weeks. I want to see how many we get. Maybe there'll be none. Maybe we've brought in all the hardcore Minecrafters today. But you are so right. There are always people. Brent, I have brought a ridiculous amount of stone to help you right now.
Just okay, fantastic. You know. Listen, I've got a bunch of noises in my ear, Rex. I've got to take a moment to
same here
chat if you don't mind. So I'll go, then you go. How about that?
That sounds cool.
Okay, so donation from Diesel Architect, another one who says, haha, that'd be cool if you guys had a Logfellas tie or pin, and that's how you gained admittance to the Logfellas HQ. Very cool idea. I love that idea. Got a really great cheer also from AC Dog. What did we call it? A ding-a-ling. Got a ding-a-ling from AC Dog 07, who says, have some mysterious internet money. Yeah, that is true. That is true. Also, a brand new sub, guys. We got sub hype in the chat, please. Zombie Brain Cocktails for Oggy Builds, who is new.
Good old Oggy.
Thank you so much, Oggy Builds, for subscribing. Over to you, X.
You should have gone Oggy, Oggy, Oggy.
Oggy, Oggy, Oggy.
Oi, oi, oi.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling.
I don't know what to reply to with that. Again, all I can hear is Shabaranks in my head. Oh. So yeah, over here we've got a new subscriber, Cox01. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Do appreciate your support. And we also... Oh my god, there's lava here.
Yeah, I got lava too. I got lava problems too, dude.
Where? Jeez. Give me... Oh. Why is there, like, lava here? All of that's recent. Is Iskow in the area?
He just logged off the server, so he might have got on. He might be up to some.
I think it was because I don't want to point fingers. Hey, is that you? Oh, it was you.
I was thinking. Sorry.
There's no one around. I know Iskal's watching. I was about to say I don't think he's the sort of person to do that, but he's the only other.
I almost burnt you alive. I'm sorry, dude.
It's quite all right. So I got some resubscribes here from Ron Bashar for 13 months, over a year. Incredible stuff. And we have another resubscribe for 4 months from Sinji Bob. We have a resubscribe from Stomp and Smash for 2 months in a row, saying, loving the stream. Keep up the good work. Thank you, my friend. And a donation here from Malavant2713Thor, saying, kind of looks like you are going to into creative to get all of that cobble with the screen blacked out. Now, all I can say is, if you know me, you know that's not what's happening. I am the person who holds on to every block they get in this game, right?
You're a hoarder, basically.
Yeah. So I am going to the place where I am, you know, recording an epicsode. So, you know, just add one and two together there. Epicsode, lots of blocks. You know, it don't take much to figure out what's going on there.
X, I have some best in chat. I've got a great viewer called Douglas Squirrel. He helps me out a lot, and he puts together all of the chats that I miss, and I just like to read out of
here. I have someone who does that for me as well on occasion, yeah.
Oh, don't you just love our communities, man? They are so freaking awesome, right?
Awesome people.
So I've got some best in chat. I missed a sub from Rebel Melody. Sorry about that, Rebel Melody. Thank you so much for subscribing, becoming a part of the Bacon Club here on Rendog TV. I very much appreciate it. Longfellas Recap Team says, suggest a subway in the Mesa using the tunnel design. A new Logfellas business? That's a pretty cool idea. An old style 1-1 says, I suggest calling the tunnel the Speedy Memorial Expressway. And Rebel Melody says we should make Logfellas t-shirts. Thank you so much, Mr. Squirrel, for that best in chat.
Awesome. Yes, the Logfellas t-shirt sounds like it could be a thing, for sure. I like the way of the subway to get around. The thing with that, though, is that what you generally want to do is be able to pick your location from where you are, where you want to go. Yeah. And if you have more than several, you know, destinations, that is quickly going to go into advanced redstone territory. You know what I mean?
However,
you know, going to a central system and then picking your location, not so difficult. But if lots of people are using the line, the redstone can easily get jangled up, you know?
That's true. And, you know, another thing, X, is that the Elytra, I mean... the Elytra killed the horse star, right? You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I know what you're saying. I'm picking up what you're putting down.
Yeah, baby. I mean, a subway is all great, but I can literally fly from my base to X's base in maybe 10 seconds.
Yeah.
You know? So the subway is a really sweet idea, but like you say, you know, with so many people, I mean, how do you manage if two people are using the line at the same time? How do you manage all of that sort of thing? But it's a very cool idea. You know, there's lots... It's weird. The Elytra has like... Ooh, there's more lava. Watch out.
I'm not where you are, so...
I'm a big fan of rails in this game. I've always loved making railway lines and stuff, but...
They're cool.
Now it's like, why even bother? You know?
Rails could do some love. They got some love recently with some redstoney rails, but maybe some other types of functional rails could add a little bit of spice to them.
I'd love a speed booster rail, you know, that like really makes you go super fast.
They did that in one update. They actually changed the way that they worked a little bit. By the way, Ren, I'm sort of getting to an area here where I think we might need a roof.
Okay.
If you want to... Oh.
Uh-oh, that doesn't sound good.
My elytra did some crazy stuff, and I'm thinking lava lake below.
Are you flying around in the nether, X?
I'm not, thank goodness. So, I'm above you, by the way. Just over here, I've noticed that this thing is coming to where you might want to put a roof, because the nether is about to open up.
Yeah, this is where it gets serious. This stretch of the line is the deadly stretch, isn't it?
So how about that height there? Does that look like it'll work?
I guess so. Well, we're going to have the glass level here, right? No, the glass and rail level here.
Yep.
So we need one more level for us to travel safely.
Yeah.
Then maybe a space in case something goes wrong and you pop out so you don't suffocate.
So one block lower.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's
good. That makes sense.
That'll save blocks in the long run as well, if you think about it. You know?
Sidra says, Rendog, is Moses the Second alive? Yes, everybody, Moses the Second, the pet rock, is alive. And I'm very happy to say that another week, Moses has survived another week. I'm trying to keep a pet rock that I bought from False Symmetry's pet shop alive in my inventory. I'm not allowed to put it in a chest or place it. And I've managed to keep this thing alive. No, I have to hold it in my inventory.
I see.
That's the deal. And it's been in my inventory now for a month, and I haven't placed it yet, which is quite amazing.
That's amazing. Don't die. So you haven't died in ages?
Nope, I haven't died in ages.
Well done. Well done, you. be extra careful today. There is many ways to die here in the Never.
I love that patronizing tone. Well done, you noob. Ghast! Oh my goodness.
Okay. Can you shoot it?
I'm gonna take it down.
Deflect the
down.
Fireballs.
Oh, it's shooting at me now! Oh! That was weird. You hit it.
What a shot. Excellent. Victory sip of me beverage.
Cup of beverage time.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Andy says, X, where's your attack indicator? That's a really good point. Where is it? Do I see it on that? No, wait. I see it on the... Where is it?
Oh man, let's see who else we got over here. A Moses t-shirt has to happen, says Sidris. T-shirt with a rock on it. McAwesome says, proud of you, Red. Thanks, McAwesome, that's awesome of you, man. Let me check, have I missed any sounds in the ears?
I've missed one. I've got a resubscribe here for 3 months in a row from Cosmic Space Lingos, saying can never catch you live, but it's Labor Day.
Labor Day?
What is Labor Day? Is that an American thing?
I feel it might be an Australian thing.
Oh, okay. Well, appreciate the support, buddy. I've just got a donation here as well from Assured Bag 822 saying, hey X, question number two. A group of friends and I are working on a MC server. We are thinking of a game mode where every 10 minutes your play changes updates. Example, you're at 1.7, then 10 minutes later you switch to 1.8, and so on. What are your thoughts on it? Well, you have to restart the server to update, and that means disconnecting, stuff happening on the server, reconnecting. If ever it went from, 1.8 to 1.1, the world wouldn't work. It would be corrupted. So, also, how much do these updates change what you're doing? Do they actually give the gameplay a real edge? 1 minute you got on elytra, then it's disappeared. I would personally be a little bit sad if I all of a sudden lost my elytra. It sounds like the idea should be more about changing the scenario through something else, not the version number, And I got a pigman in my way. Get out of my way. I don't want to make you angry.
Got loads of messages here about Labor Day. Victoria KH200, a bacon, says Labor Day is American and Canadian. Okay, we learned something new today, X.
We have learned something American new indeed. Canadian. I got a resubscribe here 5 months in a row from Pizza Manias saying, hello, Logfellas. Hello to you, my friends.
Hi.
Thank you for the resubscribe.
Hi there.
Awesome. Right, now I've got to figure out where I'm supposed to put stone bricks on this bit here. Man, this isn't like... I was about to say it's going to take a long time. We've actually done a lot in this stream. And do you find that streams are not very productive for actually getting things done?
They are the most unproductive way to play this game. Listen, a Rendog stream goes something like this. Hi, everybody. Welcome to another stream with Rendog. Today, we're going to make a lot of progress doing this or that. And then I end up literally spending the whole time either dying or noobing out or getting trolled or messing with some hermits on the server, and I literally just get nothing done.
Yeah.
Pretty much. So, yeah.
I know how that is. Right, I'm going to get this roof bit here at the entrance done, I think, next, because then it's going to give you that sense of accomplishment where it's like, okay, that bit's done, what's next?
Making progress. I'm going to start working on the deadly section.
I will leave you to that, Ren. Good luck.
I got this, man. I got this. I've been working out there in the Nether quite a while now. Goss and I have an understanding, shall we say.
An understanding, yeah.
They leave me alone. They don't get an arrow in the Goss butt.
Those ghasts never learn, though, do they? They keep shooting, they keep floating around. Do you know ghasts don't, they don't have an AI for, like, tracking the player?
Don't they?
Nope, they are always just going to drift in a random direction. And it often feels like they are tracking you, or you're trying to shoot them, they drift away. They have no control over it. They just look at you and get angry, yet literally their life is spent just floating about, you know?
Like, what are you doing to me, house? Get out of here! Blech, blech.
Yeah,
just like spitting at you.
Oh.
Disgusting beasts. Got a noise in my ear from D. Chemi, who says, had to donate to the other log fella. P.S. Make Iskall do more streams as well. Love you, Hermits. Also, good job. Moses loves you for staying alive. Thank you, D. Chemi. That is really, really nice of you. Thank you for the donation. Another noise in my ear that I actually missed, X. Sorry about that. James B. Drew 27 says, the stream of fantastic t-shirt ideas. The log fella's t-shirt would be awesome. And you and Iskall 86. Should make a Ren Skull Bromance t-shirt. That sounds like an awesome idea. Thank you so much, James B. Drew, for that idea and donation. Thank you, guys. Much appreciated. You okay there, X?
Oh, had a little bit of a lava scare. Don't worry, it didn't break anything.
Okay.
Oh, no. I did the same thing again.
Uh-oh.
How did I do that? Oh, there it is. I want to see some derp face emotes in my chat. And if you're in Ren's chat, send some there as well. I just did a big silly twice.
A big silly.
I don't understand what I did there, because I thought I filled it up, but apparently not. And so I broke the netherrack, and it just lava came down again. I don't know what to say. Oh, jeez.
That sounds like something I would do, X, to be honest with you. I always tell this guy, man, you shouldn't spend too much time with me because the derpness rubs off.
I'm already a derp myself. Chat's going crazy right now. Thank you, everyone, for the derp faces. That'll be enough, though. Otherwise it caused spam, but do appreciate those derp faces.
Oh, there's loads of derp faces coming up. Oh,
and they look so cool, don't they?
Yep. Oh. If you guys could send X some Rendog face palm faces in his chat.
I want to see them. Oh, Ren, I can't see them because someone's already sending them because I can see your little thing. I won't see them because I'm using the custom chat that hasn't been added yet. Soon it will be added. I'll be able to see all the custom emotes.
X, you're even getting some false symmetry face palms in my stream.
Yes, I can see lots of different emotes coming through. I also got a resubscribe for 11 months in a row from Panox ACV. Thank you so much for the subscribe.
11 months?
11, almost a year.
Wow, that's crazy.
One more month to go. Yeah, how long have you been on here streaming for, man? How long have you had your partnership for?
5 months. 5 months. We've been going for about... I've been streaming like on and off for about a year or so. But I only started streaming properly since I joined Hermitcraft.
Yeah.
I always wanted to get into streaming, but you know, streaming is a completely different skill to making YouTube videos.
I mean,
a lot of people don't realize how much you have to practice streaming. And a lot of people often ask me, how can I get into streaming? How can I start streaming? And my answer is always, you just have to practice. You just
start, basically, didn't you?
Yeah, your first few months of streaming is going to be awful. You're going to do really bad streams. But the more that you practice, the better that you get. And it's not like riding a bike, man. If I go away from streaming for a week or a couple of weeks, I come back, I'm rusty, man. I don't know what I'm doing.
You know, I get a little bit like that, but I've been extremely consistent, man. I have been like, you know, on the ball for a long time. I don't think I've had more than, let's say, missing two streams, I think, when I went to download. That was probably it. I'll be missing some next year. I've got a couple of holidays planned next year, so there will be some downtime. But for the rest of the year, I'm all here for streaming. I'm in my new place.
Nice.
I'm a work machine now. I'm a stream and video make machine in this place.
I'm happy to hear that
it.
You're finally going on holiday, though, X. You deserve it, man. You work way
Thank
too
you.
Hard.
I actually went on a holiday a couple of years ago to Barcelona, and it was absolutely incredible. I loved it.
One of my favorite cities in the entire world.
I can understand that. It's just got a beautiful vibe about it, doesn't it?
What was your favorite bit?
My favorite bit, I think, was seeing... Now, let's see if I can remember his name. Man, it's like it's almost on the tip of my tongue.
Gaudi,
yes, thank you so much. His architecture. like when we went and saw some of the stuff he built, It was like, I was thinking, why do I not know this person's name already? Like, this is criminal. His building, his architecture is just, it's art. It's basically amazing. Art.
Did you go to the fish house?
I don't think I did get to go to that one. I was only there for a few days. I got to saw the cathedral that's been being
built. The Sagrada Familia.
Yes. Oh, man, you remember this stuff so well.
I love
Sagrada Familia, yeah.
I've got a bit of a boring side to me. I'm into all of this stuff.
Dude, that stuff's not boring, man. I think as you get older, you really start to appreciate culture and history more. Yep. You know, you want to know more about your humanity because you learn so much more about it when you're older than when you're young. Like I've been watching and learning a lot about the 60s. Like,
yes.
All the things that happened in the 60s. Most fascinating, I think, without a doubt, probably the most fascinating part of our recent history. We're sort of living in, like, the 60s is the beginning of now. I think the internet, you could make an exception as something quite revolutionary that came later on. But so much of today's society and culture was sort of birthed, you know, in the 60s. Incredible part of
Amazing.
My history. Yeah.
did you go into the Sagrada Familia?
I went inside. It's beautiful inside. I love the color on the wall that comes through the stained glass
Amazing.
Lights. What
so
else?
For those of you out there who don't know what we're talking about, the Sagrada Familia is probably one of the most famous cathedrals in Europe. It's a cathedral, you would have seen pictures of it. It's got big fruit at the top of the spires, like
Ren,
pineapples.
I'd never seen
and
a
stuff.
Picture of it. It really felt criminal that I didn't know who this architect was. He's fantastic.
Yeah, and the building feels very organic. It feels like it's made out of mud. It's very strange building to look at. Now, the inside of the place, and it's a tragedy to me, you know, tourists go to Barcelona and they say, oh, I went to see the Sagrada Familia. And you're like, oh, did you go inside? They're like, no, it was like 15 euros. You know, I wasn't going to go inside. The inside of this place, and I'm not a religious person, but when I walked in there, it literally took my breath away. You guys know what cathedrals look like, right? You got those straight pillars holding up the ceiling and all the stained glass windows. In the Sagrada Familia, the pillars are at angles. So instead of being straight, they're at diagonal angles and stuff. So it looks like a black hole has gone off inside of the cathedral and like messed with everything and sort of discombobulated the entire building. It is really amazing.
I've actually got video of me walking around, like looking at everything. I just pulled out the GoPro and just filmed. So I completely forgot it's on my hard drive. I could just load it up and go see it again. You know,
that's awesome.
Nothing like
that's
being
awesome.
There, but very, very cool.
X, I got a noise in my ear from Mr. Theo One, who says, down with the log fellas.
Oh. We got a birch butt. We got a sneaky birch butt in here.
We got a sneaky birch butt in the house. But thank you for that donation, Mr. Theo. Very much appreciated, man.
Awesome. I've just done half of the first section of the tunnel. Whew, this is crazy. This is some crazy building, but it's going well. I've also got noises in my ear. I believe, we got those ones. So Chase Infinity has resubscribed for 2 months in a row with a big smiley face. Thank you, my friend. We also have another donation here from Assured Bag 822 saying, hey, X, that makes a lot of sense. Question number 3. This may be a dumb question, but it's for everyone, not just me. But how does someone become a part of the Hermitcraft server? What are the requirements needed, if possible? I can tell you right now, because someone new has joined the server, and they are an example of how, I guess, someone could join the server. Now, a lot of people ask, I think, with this idea in their heads that, hey, I could join the server, and it's not quite like that. There's no way of applying. It has to take all of us agreeing that we feel like, you know what, some new life in here is what we kind of need right now. And the way we would, air quotes, recruit is that, you know, we're all on YouTube, we're all active people looking at other YouTubers, seeing what other people are doing, and it's people that have impressed us, you know, made a mark on some of us that we would perhaps bring to the group and say, what about this person? And, you know, Vintage Beef is a well-respected YouTuber and Minecrafter. He's been around for a long time. He's been incredibly consistent with his, you know, brilliant Minecraft Let's Play style. And so when someone like him is mentioned, you know, there's a body of work to look at. There is a reputation, and that is basically, you know, how someone joins a community like this, is through reputation and showing that they can do what they do. If you're thinking, you know, I haven't made YouTube videos before, but I'd like to join Hermitcraft, you know, here's what you want to do. Don't look at Hermitcraft. Look at doing your own thing. Like, get some friends together, learn how to make videos together and start doing something. And, you know, you're not going to be great from day one, but you can put in time and effort. Make sure you're having fun doing what you're doing. And, you know, you'll build up a skill set. You'll learn over time how to make videos, how to make them entertaining. And who knows, one day in the future, you might catch the attention of, I don't know, some other crazy server. Maybe not even Hermitcraft. Maybe we're not a thing then. But it's about, you know, being on YouTube, being great at what you're doing, and, you know, learning to be you the best you can be. And then maybe one day someone else will spot you and invite you to something, you know?
Yeah. It's like I always tell people who ask this question, X, even the great Rendog and the magnificent Exhumed Void, we started on 0 subscribers.
Totally.
Just like everybody else. And
I was about to say,
if we could do it, you could do it. You know?
I was about to say, totally true. And then I was like, in the back of my head, I was like, not true. I started with 25 subscribers because,
oh, wow, okay.
Because I used to upload music to YouTube and my friends subscribed to me. So when technically I did start with 0, right? But when I started doing Minecraft, I had 25 subscribers and I occasionally get comments from people saying, I was your like 7th subscriber. And I'm like, yes, you're absolutely lying because I know who my 7th subscriber was. Oh, so
I'm actually
funny.
Lying to you. I had 2 subscribers. One was my mum and the other was my second YouTube
is she account. Is she still subscribed or did she go
yeah
this Minecraft ain't for me. I don't even care if it's me lad.
No, me mama loves it.
Does she tune in and watch?
She does. She tries to. She still doesn't understand what's going on.
Yeah,
but
my parents.
I often talk about her and mention her and stuff. So she likes to hear her name in the videos, you know? She
imagine,
likes it when I talk about her.
Because
so.
You're so far apart, I imagine it's probably really nice for her just to like tune in and see how you're doing, you know?
Yes, it's very nice. And she often pops into streams because I webcam my face.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, that was about to sound really dodgy, but I saved it. yeah, so she pops in so that she can see me face and stuff, you know?
That's cool. Yeah, that's fascinating.
Yeah, she's coming to stay with me for 10 days in October.
Oh, wow. And, that's cool.
Yeah, it's going to be cool, man. I was thinking about maybe doing a live stream with her, you know, getting her to play some Minecraft, see if I could teach her to play some blocks, but...
I tell you what. There's one thought is that'll be amazing and brilliant. The other thought is that some people really aren't made for computer games. You know.
That's right. I don't think my mum and dog is made for computer games.
Yeah. If she's not, you'll probably find she might struggle to like look in a direction if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Let alone grasp
everything.
My mum is the
kind of person that'll put the mouse on the screen. You know. And move it.
That's an amazing image right there, dude. I got noises. I got new subscribers again. You're
okay,
all killing it today. It's
to
amazing.
You. I got noises. So you go and then I'll go. Okay.
Commander Wolf 1 has subscribed. Thank you for your subscription. Do appreciate your support. Also, T Blank 2012 has subscribed. Do appreciate ya. Ren, I've got to say something quickly before you go, because I forgot to say this earlier. I saw someone going, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, Vintage Beef in chat. If you don't know, Vintage Beef has joined Hermitcraft. He has 2 episodes out on his channel. Google Vintage Beef if you're interested in checking out the new Hermit. Highly recommend him. He is, you know, a legend in the Minecraft community. And honoured to have him here with us, so be sure
one
to check him out.
One of my favourite YouTubers of all time, in fact. I'm still a little bit, like, speechless that I'm playing on the same server as Vintage Beef. I'm like, what? This is crazy.
It's given me a wave of energy.
Yeah, he's a fantastic content producer. You guys should definitely go check him out if you haven't.
I got a story to tell you as well, but you go do your thing quickly and we'll come back to that.
Oh yes, I got some noises in my ear. So I've got a brand new subscriber, Commander Wolf, also.
Check this guy out, subscribing to both. Double sub.
Commander Wolf. New
sub hype,
double sub. Don't be bringing cocktails for Commander Wolf, please. Thank you so much, Commander Wolf, for joining the Bacon Club here on Rendon TV. And I also just wanted to say, I see in the chat there's loads of people who are watching this stream from my perspective for the first time. I just want to say a big hello to all the new viewers.
I'm sure
most of you guys are X-rays, so I'm very honored and very happy to have you guys here. Thank you very much for hanging out. And you know what, X? I'd like to find out from my people, how many of you guys are dual streaming right now? We told you guys to dual stream. I want to see how much dual stream action is going on right now, okay? If you guys are too... are lazy.
The chat's got to blow up, man. It's got to blow up.
People are lazy, X. You know, you tell them to dual stream, they're like, eh, can't be bothered. You know, I want to see the people who are dual streaming right now. All right, that's it from me. I'm done.
I, Biharwar, says, legends say Asuma may reply. The legend is true. I love those comments. I do feel a little disheartened when I read them on my channel, because I was known for the longest time for one of those YouTubers that, you know, reads all their comments and stuff. And then it got too big for me to keep up with, you know?
I remember you talking about it in, I think it was your final video of season 3.
Oh yeah, I might have. And then it kind of got away to me from the point where like it just seemed to feel different. Always different faces, the familiar ones you don't see as frequent because there's more people commenting. It's just one of the like side effects of growing, you know, and it's a little bit of a shame sometimes. I got a donation here from Dear Shemmy saying, did your tea get cold now? Dear Shemmy, I did not have tea. I had honey and lemon, and I'm going to drink the last bit right now.
I'm going to have a sip of my beverage. I think my tea is pretty cold right now. Hold on.
Mm. So I got a story to tell you.
Ooh, man, it's nasty. I got a story to tell you, Ren, about
Me and vintage beef. So as much as I love beef and think he's fantastic, not everyone you can record with, you know, like you and me have no problem. But just because you can't record, you know, with someone doesn't mean anything negative. And yeah, you know, I've changed a lot. Man. I've changed a lot since I last recorded with beef. But back then I was Mr. Redstoner. Talked with boring voice. Vintage beef.
Hello, everyone.
Place the redstone wire there, and it will make a tea flip flop. And he's like, "What magic wire?" Yeah,
magic wire.
So we were paired up for Redstone Wars with Generic B and. Generic B and Paws and me and Beef and we actually recorded a video together, and it must be like 4 years old, and that was like when he had I think 12,000 subscribers and I had like 8,000 or something like that. I mean, stories for you, like we go way back, like this
That's
Minecraft
crazy.
Scene
That's
has been
back,
around
man.
Yeah for a long long time, you know what I'm saying?
That's funny. Magic wire.
That's what he calls it, man. I love it. I always remembered that. Magic wire. So funny.
That makes me think. It's so weird, right? To go back to your old videos. I mean, I've got like a really long-term survival series going on, right? So I'm on like episode 420 or something of the series.
Wow.
And one of the most common comments I get is, Ren, you sound so different now to than when you did back then, you know? And it's one of the funniest people. And I'm going to put him on the spot here, Rex, but I just want to implore everybody out there to please go and watch Iskull's 85's early videos. They are hilarious. They are amazing. Oh, like it's
What is it about them?
Oh, he's just like a completely different person.
Yeah.
He's so like bored. That's the best way to put it.
Watched my old videos?
Yeah, it's very similar to you. It's like, hello everyone, playing some Minecraft. I'm gonna like, make a house.
There's an easy way of explaining this, Ren. Right? Like, how many people do you talk to and they go, you know, what is up, everyone? How are you doing? Hi, my name is X. What are you up to? Like. Yeah. People don't generally talk like that when they're out about. What it is you spend so much time recording that you get this freedom to like express yourself because you talk for a living, and it evolves over time. And it's so many YouTubers are like that. You go back, it's like they picked up the microphone for the first time and they're like, they're just talking as if they're on the phone or something, you know?
Yep.
Yeah, I'll hold. All right, I'm placing a block. You know, like that kind of thing. And then over time, you know, you start growing, you start doing it constantly, you evolve, you know?
I always worry, though, that, you know, like, the new is not as good as the old. Does that make sense?
I think, like, for the person doing it, the journey is what counts. So, like, new, old. I think for people watching, it's probably easier just to stick with the new stuff. However, going back, you know, it's quite interesting. I get lots of comments. I pick them out, you know, when I'm going through my videos. I see, oh, look, that's an old video. And I look at it and it's like, yeah, someone's gone back and watched it and they're commenting about the voice. I always find their opinions really fascinating because some people go back and they're like, man, even though, you know, like you sound different, you're doing the same sort of stuff, you know. And I always find that interesting. Some people don't. Some people are like, man, this sucks. Like, you sucked back then. And I'm like, oh, jeez. Like, no need to put that there. Come on.
Yeah, jeez. That's a little bit of a low blow. I mean, suck is, you know, that's a hard word.
Dude, I have, you know, we were talking about, like, you know, you're growing and more people in the comments. And I'm trying my best to be more active where I can. Like, I've got YouTube on my phone now. So if I'm sitting on the bog, pick up the phone, answer comments. Next time you read a comment, think about that. What? Huh?
Thanks for sharing that with us.
Yeah. So anyway, I've noticed there's some nasties now. Like, it's really weird. Like, I think I think when you just get those videos, because I got a few videos that just generate traffic, you get people from all over the place, and I don't know why, but you seem to attract people that just seem like feel the need to be mean, and I've had a few more of those lately. I get the occasional like, "What is wrong with you?" And it's, "What's wrong with me?" I don't know.
Yeah.
What's wrong with you? You left a comment.
I get quite a lot of that. I mean, I'm pretty weird. I often get called very weird. I have a weird intro, and I say butthole a lot and stuff. And
you do.
When people stumble across my videos from, you know, somewhere on the internet, I get loads of those comments. I've been doing this for 5 years, and I have definitely grown like a very thick skin.
Oh yeah.
I don't get affected by troll or hate comments at all. I actually just laugh at a lot of them.
I get affected.
Seeing the creativity of them, you know.
Yeah.
that's what I enjoy. So it doesn't actually bother me at all, honestly. It's it used to bother me a lot, and I used to reply to those messages, you know, which was really bad. This is kind of like a tip for you guys who are trying to make YouTube videos.
Ren, I used
don't
to
ever respond.
Used to deliberately respond to people that were mean, and I'd try and leave something nice that would win them over. And a lot of the time, the response that I would got would be, "Oh my god, you replied! Like, I can't believe that! Like, wow, thank you!" And I'm like, what? And I realised that some of them even said it. They think no one's listening, so they just swear or say something horrible. It's a really sort of strange pattern of thought. But what I find is that when I see someone leaving something mean, I often sort of think, man, they probably had a bad day. Do you know what I mean? Like, if you're coming to the internet to someone's random video and you're calling them, I don't know, a dog poop or something, like
dog poop. Yeah, you dog poop.
Then you know they've probably had a bad day. They've probably had a rough day. Yeah, sure. Leave them alone. Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. Oh, I got a noise in my ear, X. Let me quickly give a shout out to Zlotan Leo. Oh,
Nilo is what I say. It's wrong.
Yeah, I think I've completely butchered that name. But thank you very much, Zlotan Leo, for that donation. I really appreciate it. And I've missed a freaking new sub also. Oh, I'm so sorry. So sorry, guys. I missed a brand new sub. Electrostatic has sub. New sub hype in the chat, everybody. Zombie brand cocktails from the Bacons. Do you run out of oxygen when you stream?
I don't know. You've made me wonder if I ever do that now. I don't think so. Not that loud, I don't think. I've also got a donation from Slot Nilo, so thank you so much. I do appreciate that. Says, love the co-op streams. Yeah, the people really love it, don't they? And yep. Twitch Media Master has subscribed to the channel. Thank you for your subscription. Do appreciate the support.
Awesome.
People are loving this, man. I was not expecting any of this today. I thought, you know, we'll stream. I didn't even think about how people would react. It was just like, I'm looking forward to doing this, you know.
Yeah, me too, man.
And man, I mean, people are going ham. They're going ham.
The only thing that worries me, X, is that we, you know, like usually when you stream solo, you know, you're talking with your peeps like all the time. You're interacting with each other. Like, I love dual streaming. I dual stream with Iskall all the time.
Are you saying we should give them the mic?
Well, that's probably a bad idea.
Oh, okay.
But if you just hand the mic over to them.
Oh, not like that.
Oh, you
not
mean
like
metaphorically
that.
Speaking.
Metaphorically, yeah.
Yes, well, that's exactly what I'm saying, yeah.
Amazing.
And maybe we spend a little bit of time just going back and forth, see what some of these peeps have to say. Because I feel like whenever I stream with Iskall, I have the same kind of feeling. I'm like, oh man, I'm having such a good time with my buddy. But
yeah,
I want to talk to the peeps too.
So I got a message here.
Maybe we could do something, right? So like, you do...
I do one, you do one.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Let's try that.
So I got one here from Ute Boop, who says, "Hey X, just got here. What you doing? We are having the most amazing stream ever, aren't we?"
Yeah, man, we're having a great time.
It's fantastic.
I've got one here from Bao Z, who says, "What's this slime machine? This is the fastest mode of transport that you can make in Minecraft Survival. Makes you travel at 40 blocks per second. And X and I are working on it right now."
Awesome. I've got a message here from X Fan for Life saying, "X, you never notice me. Liar." Ren. I'm joking, bud.
Oh man. Zoe Ray says, "You missed my subscribing too, but it's okay. The stream is still fun." Zoe, I'm so sorry that I missed your subscription. A big thank you to you for becoming a bacon here on the Ren Dog channel, Zoe. Thanks very much.
Ren, I've got a beggar in chat.
Hey.
Asuma, I've been begging for you to read this message. I just wanted to know, what do you think about a No Man's Sky themed tunnel? For example, black stained clay as walls and sea lanterns every now and then to make it look like you're using hyperdrive. That has got to be the most fantastic suggestion for this tunnel If I'd have known before we started placing down all of this stone brick, Brent, I don't even need to say it. It would have been what we had done, right?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. That's
completely
a fantastic
brilliant
idea.
If I build another tunnel like this, I need to remember that.
Yeah. Got an interesting question here from Via Justin. Can you talk about how to build a Minecraft community? Interesting question. I suppose what you're saying is how to build a server, a group of servers. I mean, X, I think the easiest way to start off is by getting a group of your mates together, put some money together to rent a server, and just go for it, man. Just hang out.
Gonna give a shout out to CubeHost. Go to the Hermitcraft videos, look in the description box. Yep. Discount code, great service. Been using their service for a long time. You know, they're awesome company.
Get a great service. And you know what? You can even take it further. You set up yourself a Discord channel for all of the people on your server so you can all chat to each other. You can set up a forum where you could post screenshots and stuff. The thing about setting up a Minecraft community, X, and I think you will agree, is somebody just has to put in the work because it's a lot of admin work behind the scenes to keep the whole thing running. So
yeah,
if you've got someone who's willing to do it, you know, it's just literally someone's got to do the grunt work, basically.
Absolutely. I had a message and I hit pause, and then the pause, I don't know if I paused it or unpaused it, I messed it up. But I was going to say, I got a message from Rocky Avalon here. I've got a message from Rocky Avalon here. That was his message. It creased me up, but then it went off the screen. I'm like, oh no.
I got a message here from Bacon Steve Zace, who says, is Evil X the log father Exuma is refusing to answer?
I saw his comment earlier. Evil Exuma's been permanently banned until episode 666. So you can't be a log father if you're banned, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Banhammer.
That was your one, wasn't it?
That was my one, yeah.
I'm picking out two messages from my buddy Mayschool saying, air quotes, work. I call this a hobby. I'm not sure if he's referring to me or not, or to him, because Mace does a lot of what you would call work, running servers. But that's his hobby, because he's got a passion for doing work. Man, the guys that run my server, they are, you know, they're all in the know-how with the coding and stuff. Like, I find it fascinating, all of that stuff. There's so much jargon, I just feel like I drown in it, you know what I mean?
Absolutely. My guys are amazing also. I have no idea how they do it. They're amazing. Got an interesting question here, or comment here from Scroller, who says, who runs the Hermitcraft server? X, over to you to answer that one. I'm the newest member here on the Hermitcraft server, so...
It depends what you mean by the term run, because basically we don't have a leader. So we have to organize ourselves, you know, everyone talk and discuss and make decisions. However, I'd consider myself, as I've said before, like the steward. I do as much as I can to keep this server, this community alive and having interesting things to do, you know, like I put my effort into it. I got a message here. Wait, where is it? did the pause work? Wait, give me a second. There it is. It did pause correctly. Joker's Assassin says, CubeHost have always treated me well too. I've maintained a CubeHost server for a couple of years for my friends and myself to play on. You see, Ren, I'm not one of these people that really likes working with companies or, you know, shouting them out or having business deals. But the relationship we've had with them has always been, you host our server, we shout you out, and I think we actually helped their, like, you know, their business get going in the beginning. And so we've always had a very healthy, no money involved relation, which is really good. And I'll always be happy to recommend them, because I've had my own personal servers outside of Hermitcraft. They've always been responsive to tickets, you know, the ticket system, and yeah, the whole experience has been really good. And yeah, there you go. You know, there's a Ren, I got to steal your thunder a little bit. I know it's your turn, but I just noticed Ragu42 is in chat. The man who made this crazy thing
Here.
If you peeps love technology like this, put some love hearts in chat. Show him, you know, some love, because these people share these crazy, awesome, amazing contraptions, and we all benefit from them, basically. He says the 1.9 snapshots allow for even faster transport, 60 milliseconds. That would be like an extra 50% the speed of this one. Unfortunately, those designs don't work anymore. That's a real shame. I had no idea you could go faster than this. 60 blocks a second.
That's insane. That's discombobulation on another freaking level, man. That's crazy. Dude. Big shout out to Raggy42. Also, man.
My chat is blowing up. Thank you for all of the hearts, everyone. Appreciate that. Now throw me your questions because we need to get back to it. Ren, I believe it's your turn.
Okay.
You have two this time.
There's loads of hearts going on, so I'm going to see if I can pull out a question from here. Favorite log type, Ren says. Oh, wait. No, I'll get. Let me backtrack. There was a question from somebody. Hold on. Oh, my. I'm sorry, X. We were going so well. It was so professional, and I've just ruined it.
It's quite all right. Quite all right. Do you want me to pick out a message?
No, it was a very important question, in fact. I don't know who it was from, but somebody asked, Ren, are you working on the Hermit Quest map? The answer to that is, hell yes, working with Iskall on the next season of Hermit Wars, which is going to be called Hermit Quest. For those of you guys who are interested, Iskall has put out basically a intro video for Hermit Quest on his channel, and I'll be putting out a video this week too. So, yes, I am working on the map. It's going to be amazing. You guys thought Hermit Wars 1 was good? Whew, man. You guys have no idea what you're in for. It is going to be
Hermit
amazing.
Hermit Quest will blow your mind.
Yep.
Okay, so right now my screen is black. I want, no panic in chat. Calm down. I'll turn it back on in a second. I've got a question picked out, though. And it's a really great question. I don't think I've ever heard this question before, but I instantly feel like it's a cool question to respond to. So someone is asking, T-Blank 2012, who is a subscriber, by the way, thank you for subscribing, says, hey, X, any recommendations from someone that is moving from PS4 Minecraft to PC Minecraft? Now, there are two things I want to talk about. I'm going to take up a bit of time with this one. I apologize, Ren. Mojang are pretty genius for putting Minecraft on all platforms because they migrate so many players back to PC by doing that. That they are getting people all over left, right and centre to buy the game twice. I've bought the game 4 times in total. Maybe 5, actually. I've got it on my Android and then I've got like 3 or 4 accounts, I've got 4 accounts in total. I've got a backup one for Hermitcraft, I've got EvilX, and then I've got my camera account and my main one. But anyway, so what they're asking is, like, I'm coming to PC, are there things that I should know about? Straight away I'm thinking, like, yes, but there's so much stuff we have on the PC that's different from console that you forget about, like the infinite worlds, the fact that you can do stuff like alt and tabbing and keep your cursor in the game as if it's been pressed, so you can use automatic AFK farms. Basically, like, you can power play, you can run 2 Minecrafts at once, there's all this extra stuff, and I don't know quite how to tell someone how to get into that. Do you have any ideas yourself? The things that come to mind?
I mean, I think it's a really awesome thing because it's basically like playing the game for the first time. I mean, I wouldn't panic. I would just enjoy the new experience and you will discover things that are in the PC version that aren't in the PS4 version and you'll be like, wow, this is sweet. This is awesome, right?
Yeah, there's so many things.
Yeah, so I wouldn't worry about it too much. I would just enjoy it.
A big one is recording and streaming, OBS is free. It may not be your first thought. You don't have to record a video. You could just record it and watch back like the gameplay. If you die, you might have some. Oh, jeez! Oh, he's shooting at you out there, is he? Let's patch this in quick so he can't get to us.
Yep, I need to get out there again though. Gonna have to take him down to Chinatown X.
Okay, you do that, man.
Are you gonna lock me out here with the ghast?
I'm not. I'm gonna leave you a way back in.
Okay. Yep.
Oh, he's blowing up stuff.
It's me and this guy to the death. Got him.
Oh, you got him. Nice one, Ren. Nice.
Okay, I just panicked. I got a noise in here from Shirtbag 822, who says, hey, Ren, question number one. Where can we find the server people, lol? I missed what you guys said. Also, loving the stream, watching both. That's amazing. That's so awesome that you're dual streaming. Thank you so much, Shirtbag. I'm not sure what you mean by the server people. Find the server. Oh, where can we... if you want to set up your own server... Well, you can start with your friends or your brothers or sisters. That's a good place to start. Maybe people at work or at school. Get together a group of people who you know play Minecraft and say, hey guys, you want to start a server together? Even if it's just 3 of you, you can then branch out on Facebook, on Twitter, and your social media. You can find more players. Super, super easy. Got another noise in my ear from Oggy Oggy. And actually, this is 2 noises from Oggy Oggy that I've forgotten to mention. Oggy Oggy says, hey Ren, loving the stream. I know I have another person to tune in. I now have another person to tune into. That's amazing, Oggy. Thank you. And again from Oggy, he says, only just releasing a Hermit Quest video. Tut tut, Ren. I'm already on episode 3. Yep, Augie is working with us on the map. Yes, Augie, I know I'm a little bit behind. Listen, thanks so much, dude. Augie.
Oi, oi, oi. I got two messages here. First of all, TBlank2012 says, thanks, X. Been a big fan since Hermitcraft Season 2. Love those messages. Love to know how long people have been watching for. So appreciate that, buddy. Hope it helps. And what was the other message? Marnix H says, dear X, why don't you host your own server? And I think this ties a little bit into what you were just talking about. Someone was asking about hosting a server. Mm-hmm. I've done it wrong, Ren. I've done it wrong. And yeah, it got me thinking that perhaps they're not asking about Hermitcraft-style server. What if they're asking about just somewhere they can go play, you know? There are minigame servers. There are patron servers. You and me both have... I have Plot World and minigames. I know you've got the Ren... What is it called again? The Dogcast?
The Cyberdog fan server.
Yes, the Cyberdog fan server. So there are places like that as well. If you want to give yours a plug, play.assumavoid.com is my free-to-play on server with a Plot World and minigames and an amazing community. And Ren, which one is yours?
And you and I actually spend a bit of time on there coming up with stuff for Hermitcraft. So every
now
and then
we jump on
and we might be there. So that's pretty awesome. My server is a free-to-play Minecraft survival 1.10.2, 100% free-to-play. It's a beautiful survival community filled with amazingly mature mods and an amazing mature community that you can come and play on. It is server.dogcraft.net, and I do base tours from the server every month, and if your base is really sweet, then you could be in a video on the base tours. And yeah, it's just an amazing community, and yeah, I mean, that's the thing. You know, servers of all types exist in this wonderful game called Minecraft, and these servers might not be the best servers for you, but you can find lists and lists of thousands of servers that exist, and you can find a server that suits your needs. You know, if you're looking for modded, there's modded out there. You just got to put the time in to find them, I suppose. Right, X? That's the thing. You just got to do a bit of research to find them.
Yes.
But our servers are the best, though.
I had a really interesting message, and I lost track of it. And then I had a couple of other ones here as well. Oh, there it is. Okay, yeah. So, I Love Cat says, hey, X, I've been playing Minecraft since episode 462. And I started watching since 460. So, two episodes. Wow. Convinced them. So, you kind of made me play, and I thank you for it. Awesome. I Love Cats. Welcome to Minecraft. Amazing game. What was the other question that I had here?
I just kicked the pig man into the lava lake.
That was it. Mason H Gaming says, hi, X. My first live stream. Now, when people leave that message, I always wonder, are they new from Twitch or are they from YouTube coming to the first live stream?
Like, but first ever live stream ever, or first Hermitcraft live stream, or first Exuma live stream?
But Ren, without a doubt,
specifics.
There will be people watching just from Twitch alone. So maybe we should let them know that we are YouTubers, we have YouTube channels, we do streaming as well, and we're playing on the Hermitcraft server, an amazing community full of people who play on here. It's just us online at the moment, though. We do amazing things on here, and of course, we stream, we make videos. Go to hermitcraft.com if you want to learn more about our community.
And I'd also like to say, X, that we're pretty damn good-looking people.
Well, they know what you look like.
I'm looking at myself right now. I've got to tell you, man, the ladies are queuing up, dude. Damn.
If you like a guy in a mask, I mean, that just sounds terrible to begin with.
I don't know where we're going with this. Maybe we should move on swiftly.
Yeah, let's move on from that then. You got a message picked out?
Let's have a look here.
Turtle Man wants to know your IP address, if you want to read it out again.
Oh, server.dogcraft.net. If one of my mods could hop over to X's stream and just drop that in there. I think Tiggerbell might be a mod on both of ours.
I'm not sure, but I'm sure my mods will post it as well.
So server.dogcraft.net, Minecraft Survival 10.2. And if you have any questions, just ask the moderators on the server.
Spare Grissin says, Asuma has the prettiest arm ever.
I disagree with that. I've got a pretty beautiful arm too. Look at this. Muscular. That's what I'm saying.
You got them muscles. You've been lifting weight, Ren. Drinking protein shakes.
Rendar grew up on the streets, dude. I'm from Africa, man. I'm beastly. I can survive a nuclear apocalypse.
Wow, that is an impressive... That's a great superpower. Survive nuclear apocalypse. Don't mind if I do, you know?
Yep. I feel kind of bad. I kicked a pig man into the lava lake. I'm having, like, guilt issues about it now.
He won't die. He'll swim in it and be fine.
Just swimming around in some lava.
Dude, he's down there. If he hasn't despawned, he'll be down there having a swim, having a bit of a lava bath.
Yeah, loving it, man.
Just I don't know about you, but the last time I had a lava bath, I was just like, oh, do you know what? My skin doesn't like this.
It was way too hot. Yeah. It was painful,
too hot,
man.
Painful. Spent years in hospital, you know.
Yeah, he's down there eating some lava crabs.
Lava. Dude, that'd be a cool mob. Lava crabs, like little things that climb out of the lava. That'd be terrifying if you got close to the lava and little crabs just scuttled out of there and started climbing over you. Oh my goodness
Dinnerbone
me.
Dinnerbone is watching. Lava crabs.
Dude, Dinnerbone, Dinnerbone doesn't work on Minecraft anymore. He just works on the launcher, sad face.
Oh, sad face. Okay, well, if anyone from Mojang is watching, actually, while we're at it, I'd like to have a little rant, if I may. I would very much appreciate it if Mojang could add calamari into the game. Very easy, kill a squid, get some calamari, cook it for some delicious, crunchy cooked calamari. The squid do something a little bit more interesting than making freaking sacks of ink.
While we're on the subject, you know. Slabs and stairs, forget about it. What this game really needs is more food, because we don't have enough options when it comes to food.
That's what I'm saying. Calamari, dude.
What have you
it
got?
Makes
you've
perfect
got
sense.
Apples, you've got steak, you've got bread, you've mutton. Got golden apples, you've got carrots, potatoes, golden carrots, mutton.
And let's not talk about beetroot, the most useless food ever created.
Yeah. Yeah. And you can even eat it raw, but not enough. Is what I'm
it's
saying.
Garbage, is what it is.
Ren.
Yes.
Would you like to read a message from your chat, or would you like me to go?
Oh, yes. Sorry, I got distracted. I get so angry, you know. All I want is calamari, man.
I got a great one here. Kago Tom says, "I just realised that I'm still watching Asuma. Sad face. Oh my days! That paints an amazing picture in my mind. Like you're sitting, like watching someone, and it's like, oh, I'm still watching them. And it's like the sad face is like, is that a bad thing? But it's to me, it's humorous that you realise that you're still watching something.
Yep. You think
that's
he's on the
that's
blog,
really
maybe.
Odd.
That's why he's sad.
Oh Ren, I just realised that I'm still standing.
You oh, are man. Still standing.
I'm still standing. I just realised it. I thought I was sitting down. Apparently, I'm not.
Dude, you must have the stream sweats going something fierce.
Oh, like. Man, they are rolling down the arms. They are getting the shorts messy. What is going on?
Oh, man. Butterboy says, the last time I had a lava bath, I was in a corrupt chunk on the Mumbocraft server.
Awesome.
R.I.P., man.
Dude, I got a question in chat saying, how long have you been on YouTube for? I need people to keep reminding me. Feel free to leave a comment or tweet me every now and then. Like, dude, 25th of September, because that will be my anniversary. And I had an idea a while ago. And now the days are actually like 20 days. I should really start like getting a plan together and knowing what I've got to do, because I will need to take
now.
A day to figure that one out. And I had an idea a while back, and then it sort of left me. Do you have these ideas every now and then? You're like, no way, I'm forgetting that. And then you do forget it, and you're like, Jesus, why don't I write that down?
I do it all the time. I'm like that idea is so good. There's no ways I'm forgetting it. And then 2 days later, I'm like, what was that idea? I'm such an idiot. I could have just written it down or dictated it into my phone.
Yep.
Yeah, I do it all the time.
Dude, do you have notes on your phone?
Yep.
I love notes. I make little shopping lists. I think of something, I write it down. I have a video idea, put a note on my phone. So good. So
I dictate on my phone, and actually...
Is that where you talk to it and tell it what's up?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, man.
I make music also, like digital music, and when I come up with little riffs and stuff, I record
Ren,
it.
I got a story to tell you.
Yeah, go on.
Got my computer, my digital audio workstation up and running, right?
Yeah.
Man, this thing, it is beast. So I got a triple monitor set up for it, because I've got monitors that are 10 years old. When I got my new ones, like... Basically, the peeps kept telling me to, get new monitors. People sent me donations on stream. And before you know it, I had a little budget for getting some new monitors. So I had these ones that were like approaching 10 years old. And they worked fine. There was no reason to get rid of them other than people wanted 1080p videos. I could only do 720 with them. So I gave in and I went, all right then. I got these amazing new monitors. But I held on to my previous two. And I already had a backup that I picked up cheap. So I had three of them now. And now that I've moved out, I brought a new graphics card for my second computer. Mm-hmm. The old one was, you know, ancient, and this one will support three monitors at once. So now I'm a digital audio workstation. I can have three monitors open. Now, as well as
wow,
this,
that's awesome.
I also brought myself a modern keyboard for music production. I got to say, like, for the amount that I paid for it, I am so surprised at how good it is, because when you don't put a lot of money into something, usually you don't get a lot in return, right?
Yep.
And this time around, what I basically got is where they've cut out the traditional everything's included inside the keyboard. It makes all the sounds. All of that's been cut out. This is pure digital audio workstation keyboard. You got knobs, dials, you got drum pads, but it don't make a sound. It just sends MIDI. And because of that, it's a lot cheaper. And it is absolutely brilliant, because it's the only thing that I use it for is controlling my VSTs, my virtual instruments. And I've been loading it back up, man. And I've got, unfortunately, I can't just continue where I took off. Like, I don't know what's up with it. It's years old. Stuff breaks. But I'm going to slowly reinstall everything on Windows 10. And I'm going to get the latest edition of Fruity Loops. And I'm going to get back into my music, man. And it is going to be amazing. I'm already thinking about all the things that I'm going to like compose and create.
Yeah, you got to get back into it. I use a program called Reason 8.
Yes, I'm aware of Reason.
It's a fantastic program. And I also use Fruity Loops too, but mostly just to like rip samples from it for a Reason. But I got a noise emir, X. I want to talk a bit more about music though.
Okay.
But let me just do the noise. Assured Bags donated again with the question, can you say the server IP again, just a little slower? It is, this is my fan server, I assume he's asking for, server.dogcraft.net. If one of my mods could please write my fan server address in the chat, that would be good.
I'm going to do it even slower, Ren.
Yeah?
S-E-
Oh my God.
V-
You've only got 15 minutes left, dude.
No, I got it wrong. Let's start again.
You got it right. You didn't even spell it right.
Hang on, S- do you know what, Ren, one was fine. Never mind.
Okay, so check it out, right? I came up with a sick beat the other day. You wanna hear it?
I do, but just for a second. Swiss Piplup says it's called a MIDI controller, not a MIDI keyboard. I study music in college. Sound engineering is one of my backup. Well, that's a great backup career choice. Jeez, wouldn't mind that as a backup. Ren, by the way, is your stuff friend? When you say here, you're gonna play it down the thing, yeah? Is it all friendly?
Yeah.
All your stuff is full commercial,
it's all good.
Yeah?
It's all good.
Okay, cool.
Iskall's put the address in the chat. Thank you, Iskall. I love you, man. So check it out, right? I came up with this beat. I was walking in me town, and I came up with this beat. Let's see if you guys can hear it. It's recorded on my phone. So check it out. Can you hear that?
Dude, are you beatboxing that?
Yeah, that's
the whole
my
thing.
Mouth.
You're a beatboxer, man.
That's with my mouth. That's with my mouth.
That's really good. Yeah.
It's not bad, right?
It's impressive, man. Here I am talking about copyright. It's just you beatboxing.
Yeah, that's the tune that I'm working on at the moment. I have another noise in my ear, though, X. Sorry, dude. Sir, thanks a lot. Says, you guys should do some teleshopping together. You could literally sell anything. Please do more streams together and have a nice glass of wine with your next meal on me. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. I don't drink wine, but I will have a tasty beverage on you. And thank you very much for that donation. And we appreciate the love, man.
I got an idea, Ren.
Yeah, go on.
We haven't done a Hermitcraft stream day in a while.
I
don't know if Beef streams, but maybe he'd be interested in being involved. Perhaps if we did do something like that, we could kick it off with a Logfella stream.
Man, that sounds like a cool idea. I would like to propose that we perhaps get our Swedish brother from another freaking mama involved too.
Triple stream,
man, baby.
We'll destroy Twitch with that. People won't even know how to put that on their screen. It'll be too much video.
Let's see, guys. How would you feel about an Exuma Rendog Iskall stream?
I'm expecting my computer to just start whizzing as it has to process all these chat messages coming in.
Yeah. X, come back to the beginning here of the tunnel.
Okay, yeah.
If you will. Because, like, I just came back here and my mind kind of just went...
Okay.
Because it looks awesome.
It does. It does look awesome, doesn't it?
It looks so cool. But yeah, I wanted you to take me through what you've done, because we've both been working on completely different things at the same time.
I've just been placing stone brick after stone brick after stone brick.
I feel like I've been placing stone bricks for an hour and 45 minutes right now.
That's pretty much what we've been doing. I tell you what, we've got 15 minutes left. How about we do a little bit of tourage, perhaps? We actually like really got stuck in and did a lot of work.
I know we joke
about not doing a lot, but whenever we were talking, I was placing blocks. You know what I mean?
Yep.
It was productive.
Iskall's here inspecting the work.
Did he get his diamond back? I'm not sure if he knew where I put it.
Oh, got a noise in here from Jordan2106, who says, boop, hey Ren, I compose my own music too. I'm a guitarist and play metal, but I love all types of music, and Asuma and Ren Dog Logfella original song could be cool.
Horns for you. Horns in the air, Ren.
Yeah, horns in the air. Yeah, baby, you get some horns from me. Got a little bit of ding-a-lings in the air also from Wintergrave, who cheers and says, Ren Skull Void stream, I guess is what he's saying. Oh, man. That's,
dude. I want to send you the Shabarank song now. It's called Ting-a-ling.
Ting-a-ling.
Yeah, look it up, people, man. You know what I'm on about when he says ding-a-ling-a-ling.
Iskall says, has Direwolf 20 been here? Notice me, senpai. Does this look like a Direwolf build at the moment?
I don't watch Direwolf. Do you know, so many people say, like, go watch Direwolf to learn. I just don't learn by watching people play modded. Like,
yeah.
I'm one of those people, I think this is how I learn, right? I need to bang my head into the wall and then go, that hurts, should I stop doing that? And you go, yeah, stop doing that. And I go, yeah, yeah, got it. If you said, don't bang your head in the wall, I'd be like, what? That doesn't make sense. Do you know what I mean?
Yep.
Like,
yep.
I learn by doing and asking.
Yep.
Got a great comment here
from Jacob Stain, who says, Ren and X, notice me, I love your vids so much, and I just subscribed to both of you.
Hey, thank Ren.
Jacob Stain, that's awesome.
Should we bless the chat? Should we notice everyone in chat all at once?
What, all at the same time?
I just noticed everyone in chat. You've all been noticed. Go
noticed
ham!
You all. You've all been noticed, okay? Oh, man. Dude, you were talking about a little bit of a tour.
Yeah, so, yeah. Peeps, you if you're new to Hermitcraft, hermitcraft.com, this is where all the amazingness happens. Streamers, video makers coming together on the tubes, on the Twitches, and providing you with tons of entertainment, including this guy. Although all this guy ever does is he just stands there and he doesn't say anything. Look.
Yeah, look at him. I mean, like, push him around.
Oh, he moves.
Oh,
okay, he moves as well, and he says things in chat. But he can't talk like we can. I mean.
No. I've got a noise in my ear, X. Sorry, Diesel Architect is innate. It says, Red Dog, Exuma, and Iskall are my favorite combo. You're all so funny together. I need some Hermitcraft merch from you guys. Thank you, Diesel Architect. Man, people getting hyped for the triple screen stream action,
yep,
X.
It's going to happen. I've got a resubscribe for 2 months in a row from MookNoobie1972 and a new subscriber, MookKazu. Thank you for subscribing. Do appreciate the support.
I will never get tired of listening to you trying to read people's names.
Oh yeah, I do the butchers, don't I?
It tickles me, man.
I am thinking, should we go check out Force's place? Force has got an amazing build style, and I'm thinking, who do we go check out? Now, this guy's right here, and he's got an amazing base too, so maybe we'll go there after. But I toured his base with him the other day, so... It is really... What?
Well, I mean, obviously, your build... I wish I could just pick your build up and stick it in the blue. Then the district would be perfect.
Hey, there's some other cool builds down there as well.
Yeah. That's true. There's amazing builds all over this server, man.
Oh, yeah. The way you get to Forces is at this back one. I forget that.
Oh, yes. She's got her own little portal thingy here. Oh, look who's just joined. Good times with Scar is in the house.
Now, there's someone with an amazing base.
Wow. Yes. Yep.
I
someone
tell him
I've
streaming.
Learned a lot from, like, just playing Minecraft with. From the building side of things, it's crazy.
what is this monstrous? Oh, there's a rotten smell coming from this building. What is that?
I love this. It's like the first thing.
Oh, look,
that
it's made out of dog poo. Look.
Yeah, look at this.
A poop.
X, I love this. We're supposed to be showing off the server to new people, and the first thing we see is a giant block of birch.
I know.
No, we're kidding.
Birch
this
butts.
Is Cub Fan's
what can you
build.
Do?
It's going to be amazing when it's finished.
You know, like, jokes aside, man, have you seen his base down here? It is. Freaking gorgeous. I mean, and he's got that thing over there. I don't even know what to call that. Just Minecraft level a million.
Yep, done in survival. Ooh, people don't ask me how he did it, but yeah, it's here, it's burning a hole through the wall, and it's amazing.
It's almost hypnotic looking. it's like I'm gonna hear this ominous voice, you know, telling me to do something.
I mean,
turn around, look the other way
right now.
I got a new subscriber. Here it is, Semtrex1. Thank you for the subscription. Do appreciate it. Hope you're enjoying the stream.
Dude, this is like Actually, that's probably a bad idea.
It looks like you're being brainwashed when you stand in it.
Yeah. Oh. Don't want to trigger anybody in there.
Is that Scar? Wow.
Yeah,
Elytra's.
That's Scar flying around.
Look at this place, man. We've got a giant olicopter over there. We've got a floating wasp, a jellyfish in a mesa, mushrooms, and this lovely little... What does he call this thing again? There's a word for it. And he says it in that crazy southern accent. It sounds cool.
Yep, can't remember, but
man,
it's amazing.
It's on the tip of my tongue. Like,
Dude, Pebo. We're streaming.
Is
it's not going to happen.
Pueblo or Pueblo or Pubo or something like that?
Pubo?
Yeah, Pueblo. I think it's something similar to Pueblo. I'm going to look in chat because someone's going to correct me on it.
So that's beautiful.
Distractions galore, Ren. Where are we going next?
Let's go to Scar's Catland.
Oh.
And you'll notice a lot of cats around here. Scar's got a strange obsession with cats.
Ren, can you say this word? It's P-U-E-B-L-O.
Pueblo.
I say
Pueblo.
It?
Pueblo.
Pueblo, that's it. Yeah, it's all the Pueblos over here. Man, I like the way he says it. Is Cub's accent southern? It's sort of not southern, but it sounds like it would be south rather than north. I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. I don't know my accents.
I don't know either. I don't know if he's southern or not. I really like his voice, though.
Yeah, it's cool. He's got a cool mannerism about him. Mm-hmm. So I've lost... Oh, no, I found you.
Hi.
Timing.
I got lost in Catland. This is Scar's area. Freaking
there
sweet.
He is.
Yeah, man. There he is,
cake,
Scar. Eating his little... Is that a Victorian sponge cake?
It looks like one. Do you want to know something about cakes? I believe they have zero saturation. If you lay down a load, try and do some work, and then eat cake, it disappears as soon as you eat it. It's useless. It doesn't regenerate your health either.
I thought you were talking about real cakes.
Oh, no. I was talking about the cake on the table.
So I was very confused. I was like, what?
Apparently, Cub's accent is North Central.
Ah, okay. Well, you learn something new every day. Let's head over to the Swedes base. I often get asked, what is your favorite build on the Homercraft server? And at the moment, Eskal's base is my favorite. It's gorgeous.
Really?
And
isn't there another certain build that you like?
Oh yeah. I mean, your base, of course, is the
oh,
best.
No. I was on about the Logfellas.
The Logfellas HQ. That goes without saying. I mean, when I say my favorite, I'm obviously mean my favorite only second to the Longfellas
exactly,
HQ. I mean, it's just normal.
Absolutely.
It's political. Trying to be politically correct here, X. Don't want to hurt anyone's feelings.
That's right. You know.
But it's beautiful. It's beautiful. We got loads of castles in the skyline here also. Just epic.
Ren, don't go anywhere. Stand right there. Quickly. The Bringer of Death has subscribed. I mean, a little bit grim, but thank you for subscribing. Please don't bring no death. Ren, we're going to do something. You see that big hole in the ground over there?
Yeah.
Can we fly into it with our elytras?
Can we butt boost?
You got your butt boost, Bo. I want to see you give it a shot. I'm going to try it from here organically.
Okay, I'm going to try organically too.
Okay, go for
it. Hey! Oh! Yeah!
Oh! Oh, well done! No, wait, I jumped wrong! Oh, I'm in! There we go.
Nice work.
I was kind of picturing myself coming in and then flying through here. Oh, if you could make that, then you could turn into this. Yep. That's
there
a challenge
an
right there.
In here.
If Iskow is watching, I'm issuing him an Iskow challenge. Try and do that. Try and fly from the top whenever you're up there. Land in this bit. Eventually, you'll get the hang of it if you try enough. You can come through here and then turn to the right and you can just fly all the way through this ravine. It'd be amazing. Yep. Dude, I got a resubscribe from Bill B. 21 for 4 months in a row. Thank you so much, my friend. And I believe I missed... Did I miss Semtrex 1? New subscribe. If I did, I'm sorry. Also, an Arctic Anaconda has subscribed. Thank you for the subscription. And Thunderhawk MC for 4 months in a row saying congrats on accumulating over 1 million views. Thank you. Is that... 1 million views? Is that... Oh, no. We did that a while ago. Yes.
Yeah.
That's not a recent one, but thank you. Thank you. Appreciate that. Ren... What are we doing? We're trying to tour, and we're doing anything but touring, it feels like.
Iskal is going... He's taken up the challenge.
Oh.
He says that he can do this.
Okay.
So let's see. He's got to fly into the hole and fly straight through, without touching anything, into the ravine, without stopping.
Okay, I'm going to try and get a nice vantage point for this.
Yep. I don't know where he is. Oh, there he is. Okay. There he is.
Oh, no, he made it around the corner.
Did he?
No, not quite. He hit the ground and then got going again, but it was pretty spectacular.
That was pretty close, though. Wow.
Epic. Woohoo! Oh, wow, this stretch is on.
Yeah.
Oh, he's going back! Oh, I failed.
Oh, no. Dude, we're supposed to be going on a tour, and now we've ended up at the bottom of
What are we doing? What sort of tour guides are we? Welcome to... Oh, wait a minute, we're lost.
Welcome, everybody, to the bottom of a ravine. Why can't I say that? Bottom of a ravine.
Ravine, ravine, ravown.
It's twisting my
Ravone. Tongue. Ravoon.
But yeah, Rex, listen, man. This has been a fantastic stream. I've had a wonderful time. It's been great. Yep. And I think we got a couple minutes left. But, you know, I just wanted to say a massive thank you to everybody who's been watching. All the new... I mean, dude, the amount of new follows that has happened to Rendong TV tonight has just been crazy. So
yeah, got a lot of people following
X-rays
and subscribing over here too. Yeah,
it's been amazing. And I'm, you know, I think I speak for us both. If we missed anybody, really sorry. We try to keep up with as much as we could, but it was all going a little bit mental. I think we broke
mental
Twitch tonight.
Is the word. Yeah. Mental is the word. I am. I know we're not done just yet. I'm just seeing if anyone else is live that we can raid as well.
Oh, that's a good
just thinking
idea.
Ahead a little bit here.
Yeah, Scar might be streaming.
Rendog streaming. We could raid Rendog.
Yep, raid Rendog. Raid that noob.
Hypno is streaming, but Hypno finishes when we finish, so it looks like there might not be a raid. Oh man, this place is so cool, isn't it? All the Escallium everywhere. I love it.
This is Escallium. This is Iskull's ore, basically. I love this place. It's beautiful.
So, Ren, I've very much enjoyed your company for the stream, but I'm thinking just for the last literal couple of minutes, I want to say thanks to my peeps, if that's cool with you. You probably want to say thanks to your peeps as well.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Amazing.
So, yeah, we'll say goodbye to Exumi, everybody. And,
Ren, I'll be calling you shortly after the streams.
Yeah,
speak to you soon, my friend. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure. Bye bye. Peeps, it looks like it's just you and me now. That was amazing. Thank you so much for all the support. It's it really was quite shocking just to see how many people tuned in and you know, came in to watch today. So massive thank you to you all. Let's get some questions in chat. The Cyan Gaming says, Asuma, raid me. Are you live, my friend? No, that's not how we're going to do things here. I have to know who it is I'm raiding before I do it, so... I'll only raid someone I've seen before. Semtrek says, how about a Mobilisa stream when the game is finished? That's something we could totally do. It's a fantastic idea. Lots of people are saying thanks for the stream. I'm glad you all enjoyed it. Glad you had a good time. Put a smile on my face. I hope you're all doing good as well. And QWERTY says, dual streaming this is hilarious. Yeah, me and Ren have a lot of fun streaming together, don't we? We've got to do that more often now. I think the way out might be up there. And also got to not do that. Let's try again. Yeah, look down. Bam. Yeah, looking down after you end a pearl up is a good idea. Sammy says, X punch Rendog, please. Do you want me to anger him? What is going on? Milky Milk says, X YouTube has got some updates to their design around the website. Cool. What YouTube tend to do is do things in a beta. Oh my goodness, may you get away from it. Where they give access to like selected people at particular times. So you may see something that other people don't see, you know. Often in Hermitcraft, someone will be like, oh, there's a new upload page. And like everyone else is like, we can't see it. Extra Speed says, Asuma, what is your favorite instrument you play? I play the saxophone and I love jazz. Probably the guitar is my favorite to play, but I love drums and I love keyboards as well. Love it all, really. Hi. Oh my God, two of them. Let's get away. there are mobs around here. We've got to be careful. I see a creeper up ahead. Geez, right next to Rendog's area, he's got to light this place up, man. It's all those caves have been lit up so well that now any little spot, there's loads of them to support. Firefall says, what happened this episode? Just check the second channel if you want to catch up. So peeps, of course, come check me over on YouTube if you haven't seen me over there before. Hit follow if you've enjoyed the stream and want to catch more of them in future. If you want to know my schedule, it is down below the video. You can find it right there. I stream every other day. And the last thing I want to say is that this will be uploaded to the second channel. Rendog has logged off. I probably need to end it as well. Let's have a looky-loo. Right, am I safe to stand here for a second? I hope so. I hope we're good. Yes, so peeps, thank you so much for tuning in today. I really do appreciate it. Have a good one, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.